catamarans, all of them flexing their maritime muscle on this, the penultimate act of the season. This is the original stadium racing circuit. This is the Extreme Sailing Series. If you're looking for idyllic sailing locations with crystal waters and warm sunshine, head to California, USA and the city of San Diego. Add in a rich maritime history and seven teams made up of some of the best sailors on the planet, and you've got a perfect mix for hydrofoiling action on the GC32s and the battle to be crowned San Diego's Extreme Sailing Series champions in front of the spectators lining the course, cheering on their favorite teams. I'm Niall Myatt-Best, and joining me here in San Diego for commentary is Olympian Volvo Ocean Racer and Extreme Sailing Series skipper, Sally Barco. Sally, the last day of racing, the last race today, double points, the sun is shining, but it's a little bit light at the moment.
That's right, another beautiful day in the sky here in San Diego, but on the water, we're missing a little bit of pressure. We'll see what the day holds.
But it is a world away from the wet and wild conditions that our teams battle with in Cardiff. As always in the Welsh capital, the Extreme Sailing Series bringing you the best sailors in the world, pushing things right to the limit. Take the act win by a single point. Another win for Alinghi in Cardiff, making it their fourth and three wins in a row. Clearly a team that has risen to the challenge, the SAP Extreme Sailing team threw down last season. And this means that at the moment, the Swiss team are 2 points ahead of SAP Extreme Sailing team in second, with Oman Air 4 points behind in third. Sally, I mean, this is the penultimate act here in San Diego, and if SAP Extreme Sailing Team and Oman Air want to do something about the Swiss dominance, they need to do it here.
They sure do. They need to step it up today, and the conditions kind of account for that. There's a chance it's a little riskier day on the water. We might see some movement in the scoreboard.
It's going to be very important to see what these teams can do with the difficult racing that we've got out here on the cars today. Light breeze, and we know that is going to demand the very best from the tacticians. And racing began here in San Diego on Thursday, and out of the blocks, Oman Air and SAP Extreme Sailing Team were focused on not giving Olinghi another act win.
One, two, three, listen.
Hey!
After their near dominating performance at the start of the event, Alinghi started the second day on strong form with a win in the first race. Then suddenly, they felt the heat from a recharged and resurgent Oman Air. Phil Robertson and his team found their groove and took three wins in a row to pull back the Swiss within striking distance. Adam Manoprio and SAP Extreme Sailing Team also helped show Alinghi that they couldn't relax just yet. Also taking three wins and squeezing the top three teams together at the top of the score sheet. Day three was hot, and combined with light winds, it was a hard day for the tacticians. There was no rest in the quest for speed, as a do-or-die attitude meant that the gambles paid off, with boats being overtaken right up to the finish line. Another strong day for Oman Air and SAP Extreme Sailing Team keeps the scores tight and means the final day of racing in San Diego will be crucial. So going into today, the final day of racing after 15 races completed here in San Diego, Alinghi are in the top spot with 5 points ahead of Oman Air in second, SAP Extreme Sailing Team in third, 3 points down. Very close at the moment for those top three teams, and let's not rule out Red Bull Sailing Team as well. They need to turn it on today, and they need to keep their fingers crossed that the breeze fills in so we get the maximum number of races allowed. And we could yet see Roman Agara moving up to the podium here in America. Ineos Rebels UK down in fifth place, Team Mexico making up in seventh, and then Element Spark Compass, the homegrown team, in sixth place. Sally, full day of racing potentially on the cards today, but we do need this breeze just to get a little bit more sustained.
We sure do. I think that it's going to be tricky, just like it was yesterday for the tacticians on the water, but the boat speed should prove again. Boat handling and boat speed should be the key today.
Well, USA-flagged Element Spark Compass are in sixth, and as a wild card entry, the homegrown team are ready to prove their worth in their home waters.
My name is Taylor Canfield. I'm the helmsman on Element Spark Compass. So we actually just received a call about a week out from the event. They were looking for a local team. They had some great supporters, Element Sports Group and Spark Compass, to support a local U.S. team for this event. And getting everything in line last minute, we ended up with quite a good team here. So really happy to be competing and representing home country here in San Diego. We have John Wallace, who's trimming the main sheet on board. Next to him is Sam Halliwell, who's doing the head sail trim. And those two are always, competing everything. From the second we wake up, it's who's going to eat more breakfast, who weighs more, who's stronger. So it's an interesting dynamic. But, when it's time to go out there and race, we get the job done. Next forward, we have Matt Noble. He's doing the floating position. He's a big skiff guy. He's been sailing skiffs for his whole life. And, he's the older boy on board, so he's, enlightens us with all of his wisdom. Then up on the bow, trimming the foils and, taking care of the bow duties is Mateo Vargas. And, he's a true surfer boy at heart. So grew up in Florida, but lives in California. And he's, every morning checking the surf report and watching the World Surf League. Yeah, we're really fortunate to have a full U.S. team for this event, and two of them living out here in California, so two California boys, and definitely the home team at this event, and we love having the home crowd cheering us on. It's really motivating to know that everyone's watching and supporting us out on the water, and hoping that we can continue to get better, and we're fortunate to have thrown a great team together for the event. So. I think just going out there and trying to learn as much as we can and put some good races together. The goal is just to improve every day, every race, and just keep growing as a team. And that being said, hopefully we can put some more good races up on the board.
Taylor Canfield and Element Spark Compass Racing with a bit of a steep learning curve, just going past the committee boat at the moment. And the good news is, Sally, that we are in a countdown. But just thinking about that wildcard team, any boats here on the Extreme Sailing Series, you're up against some of the best sailors in the world. As a new team coming in, it really is going to be tough. Ineos Rebels UK, they came onto the circuit as a young crew. They've kind of established themselves, but it has taken time.
That's right. I think all these, in anything in sailing, experience is king. it takes time to develop your team, but also in these changing conditions, it takes time to actually get everybody super full, you know, full comfortable. But of course, it's the last day of racing, and you had a chance to catch up with the skippers. Let's see what they said before they got on the water.
Well, the sun is shining here in San Diego, but crucially, the wind is blowing as well. Now, Arno Sarafaga, skipper of Alinghi, you guys are in the lead right now, and I've got to ask, are you disappointed to see sailable conditions? Because, of course, if the fog stayed that was here this morning and the wind didn't arrive, you'd be walking away with a trophy. How do you feel?
Now we feel pretty confident today. It's even better if we can race on the last day and see how it goes. And the boys are ready, and I'm sure we will have a great battle with Mano and ACP today. Yeah.
I'm sure a great battle, because even though you might not be able to hear it, there's plenty of banter coming from these two as well, trying to push your team off its stride already. Adam, let's talk to you. You guys have had a fantastic regatta out here in San Diego. You've been doing pretty well. You've got a full string of firsts, but you find yourself in third spot. I'm guessing it's pretty tight up there for the final little push for the win.
It's very tight out there. Both Phil and Arno are sailing really well. Unfortunately, we started the first day of the regatta not too well, and the points we lost there are haunting us at the moment, and we were a bit disappointed to see no win this morning. But now it's filled in, and hopefully it's filling in that we can foil, because it's a lot more fun for us and the crowd, and then that's where Alinghi are weak, and that's where we'll take him down.
All right, well, there you go. Strong words there. Well, let's talk about the other man that's going to be fighting for first spot, Oman Air, Phil Robinson. Now, you guys out there yesterday, I mean, it was a tactical battle to behold. It was light winds, but you were really pushing boats left and right, getting them all out of the breeze. Today, though, the wind looks a little bit straighter, a little bit more consistent. I mean, does that play to your strengths?
Oh, for sure. Yeah. Nah, look, it's... as the other guys say, it's just started to pulse in a little bit, which is nice, and it's looking like quite a nice day right now. So hopefully it stays around and we can get quite a few races in.
All right, well, there you go. We've got three skippers, one of them on the top spot at the moment, but the points certainly very close. This is going to need to be decided on the water. Well, those are our top three skippers, and any fear of a delay to racing has evaporated because we are underway. This is the view down the start line at the moment between the white superstructure, black hull of the committee boat, and the black boy. The gun fires, and look at that. Red Bull Sailing Team, we said that they needed to do something special today, and they really have a very strong start. Oman Air coming off from the pin end at the moment. They seem to be the only boat starting on starboard.
That's right, and maybe, you know, SAP actually had a really tough start behind them. Oman Air slow here at the pin. Not what these two teams are looking for right off the line.
Well, reading the body language at the moment, we can see Peter Greenhouse crouching in front of the camera right now, a real veteran of the Extreme Sailing Series, scanning around, looking for the breeze. You know, Sally, everything about today feels pretty similar to what we had yesterday. What were the key things that we want to see our sailors doing again? What were those things that paid off?
One thing that surprised us yesterday was how many maneuvers the boats were doing to stay in the pressure. I think that the course is a tiny bit narrower and a little bit closer to shore than yesterday, so I would expect them to do, here we go, SAP going for their first tack, doing maximum maneuvers to stay in the pressure, to stay in clean lanes up this course.
Well, here's a great view down the course at the moment. All the teams at the moment, well, a majority of the teams on port, bouncing into that city wall. Then from there, you can see the boat furthest left at the moment. Alinghi tacking back out from the shore. And they're going to be crossing Ineos Rebels UK nice and easy at the moment. And we can see the code zeros being used up. We're no surprise there. It's light enough to have this sail still deployed.
It's super light, and there's not much power to this pressure. It's pretty warm out on the water. The sun is shining. It's flat water, so these boats are really trying to carry as much power as possible. We're just seeing the hulls, just the windward hull just coming up a little bit, but it's not a whole lot out there right now.
Not a whole lot, and that puts a lot of pressure on the helm, how you're using that rudder, how you're feeling that boat, and a lot of pressure on the tacticians as well. Just look at the sorry position that Alinghi have got themselves in right now. This is where Red Bull starts to reward them.
That's right. We saw them fully powered up and accelerated to their max right off the line on port tack in a clear lane. And that allows them to go pretty much wherever they want to go on this course.
Alinghi at the moment tacking out Red Bull Sailing Team. I mean, the computer right now is putting Alinghi in first place, but I think that might just be a shift. Yeah, now we can see that shift coming through. Things starting to correct themselves. Team Mexico taking a little bit of a turn to be crowned the top team. That is not going to last long. I don't think that short side of the course is going to pay. They're holding on starboard as Element Sport Compass ducks underneath them. And we saw a lot of this yesterday, the teams taking those ducks, really being happy to push themselves as far into that shore side as possible.
Yeah, I mean, sometimes in this condition, a duck is more powerful than a, well, they can't tack underneath, they'll just get rolled. So they go for the duck and they find their clear lane. They need to use the width of this course, which actually isn't that wide today, to find their lane. And you know, it's going to be tricky. There's going to be a lot of dirty lanes, and I think whoever can stay in their own lane the longest is might get to the top first.
Well, on board at the moment with Oman Air, we can see SAP Extreme Sailing Team just to leeward, and these two boats, I mean, look at it, 6th, 7th, they were the two teams that did start on starboard, did come off the line in a conventional way.
Yeah, a little bit tricky with that because they were going so slow on the line, so it already puts them sort of down on the ladder rung, as we say, behind the group, having to react to the boats that got a better start on port, and maybe were one tack ahead because now they're coming across on starboard.
Oh, look at what we're seeing here. These are good scenes for the home crowd right now. Element Spark Compass in second, first, third, certainly on the heels of Alinghi, who seemed to have wiggled their way through into a little bit of clear air. Team Mexico, they did take a turn in the lead, but you can see just how quickly that evaporates. They've tacked over, and in a moment, we're going to see Element Spark Compass sailing over all the top of them. Alinghi leading the Americans right now as Red Bull gets swallowed up in the middle of the course. Oman Air causing them real trouble as well. So the Swiss are in the lead. Now, very important to remember that the breeze today is fickle. We're not expecting the full quota of 10 races, and the final race today will be double points. So the clock is ticking on Oman Air and SAP Extreme Sailing Team. They need to finish consistently ahead of Alinghi. And as Alinghi tackled back over to consolidate their position, the opposite is happening right now. Alinghi sailing through with a little bit of breeze. They'll want to keep it as they make their way back over to the middle. You can see just how congested this race course is. We are sailing upwind to the windward gate, the two yellow marks. That does give these teams some options, but with this harbor wall here, I mean, the race course certainly does feel pretty squeezed in.
It sure does, and it seems like streaky like it did yesterday. Alinghi there in the, you know, far right on your screen have just had a nice line of pressure. To me, they have a little extra gear in this light stuff. I don't know if it's the way the boat's set up with how they're managing the pressure, but they came from in the middle of the pack and squeezed through the group and are now like having a nice comfortable lead.
Oman Air are making their way through, but the team in the lead, there's no doubt about it. Alinghi, they are narrowing in on the top of the course. Looking out from our commentary booth on the shore right here, I can tell you that they're in breeze. They have got wind around them, so it looks like their path to the windward gate is going to be clear. Just slightly under the ley line, but we do know these GC32s, they like to tack and come out at a low angle.
They have a really low angle in this pressure to power the boat up and to start accelerating again. They're going to lose a lot of boat speed in the turn. It's like turning a huge wide platform, finding the angle to accelerate, and then once they're moving through the water, they can sail closer to the breeze.
On board with Alinghi as they complete their second tack. Now, they didn't need to do that maneuver, but by doing that, we can read something about their tactics for this downwind leg.
It really feels like they want to stay close to this shoreline. They made the choice to sit to start on port, be the first ones into shore, but then also make this extra maneuver at the top to sail close to the shore with this pressure.
And look at the difference with speed here as Alinghi put that extra tack in. Element Spark Compass, no need for that second tack. They lined themselves up for that rounding some way back, and they've got plenty of pace at the moment. They're going to be hot on the heels of the Swiss. And of course, as we go onto that downwind leg, it's the chance for the boats behind to start blocking the breeze and taking control of the situation. Well, next to come round, Oman Air, what a turnaround in the second half of this beat.
They must have found such a clean lane there in the middle. Do one less maneuver and all of a sudden they're back in, you know, in the middle of the group, top three, that's what they need.
Are you happy with that?
On SAP Extreme Sailing Team also managing to wriggle their way through. Red Bull Sailing Team, the boat that started so strongly from the middle of the line, is having to give SAP Extreme Sailing Team the room that the rules require at that windward mark. It's going to be a slow bear away for SAP Extreme Sailing Team. Expect Red Bull to roll over the top. But Adam Rinoprio, he's done well to stay in the fight here. The points are going to be absolutely crucial here between SAP Extreme Sailing Team, Oman Air, and Alinghi. At the moment, it's going the way of the Swiss. Ineos Rebels UK, Team Mexico will be next to come round. This is disappointing here for British fans. Ineos Rebels UK have not found the gear that they want in the light San Diego wins.
I think there's something to be said here about the boat speed. These boats are needing all the momentum to carry through the water. So whether it's the acceleration out of the maneuvers or the general boat speed with this wind condition, it's kind of a really specific boat setup. And I think Alinghi has a boat going through the water really well and accelerating well, maybe the best out of the group. And maybe Ineos Rebels UK are struggling the most.
Well, let's look at this battle just unfolding at the moment. We've got Oman Air to windward of Element Spark Compass. This is the role that will put Phil Robertson into second place. I was doubtful there as to whether they would clear the bows of Element Spark Compass. And I was doubtful as to what exactly was going to come from that maneuver. Oman Air rolling over the top of Element Spark Compass. They were able to clear enough room to jibe onto port and sail their way through. That's going to put Phil Robertson into second place. They are closing down here on Alinghi. But they've got a new challenge here, because as Phil Robertson looks over his left-hand shoulder, he'll be able to see Red Bull Sailing Team coming in from the harbour wall. There you can see them. It's not going to be enough for Red Bull Sailing Team, but they could jibe here and still cause a little bit of problems for the breeze in Oman Air sail.
Good.
Looks like they're going to cross over, but huge gains for Oman Air as they actually took a big chunk of the lead out of Alinghi. Remember, in the overall scores, that's their fight. Their fight is in front of them. They're just going to be trying to possibly put a jibe in here on Alinghi's breeze.
So no worry for Oman Air if Red Bull Sailing Team get in front of them and Alinghi. Equally with Element Spark Compass, that's fine. This is explaining why Phil Robertson and Oman Air is sticking to the Swiss so much on that downwind leg. Alinghi jibing over, light winds, crew forward. Now, I'm surprised that Oman Air doesn't attack in this situation.
I agree, but maybe he learned something from yesterday, which was that, you know, Phil Robertson and Oman Air tried to control the race when they were from the front, and they didn't go for the breeze, they didn't go for the pressure. Now, maybe he's thinking, look, we actually need to sail around these guys, so we need to sail really our own race and call better shots.
Well, they've given themselves a very healthy ley line at the moment. They're going to be able to come out of this jibe quite nicely high, build some power, and still be able to get down to the bottom of the course without needing to do an extra jibe. The Swiss, meanwhile, are in front of them, further to windward. And as you can see, Alinghi right now, on the right-hand side of your picture, going a little bit slow. That could be the soak that they're needing to make.
That's right, a crucial angle here, crucial ley line. I would assume Alinghi are going to go for another jibe rather than sailing low and slow, as we say, into this gate. But really powerful for them to round the same mark as Oman Air and take away some of that risk.
It might be that the Swiss are just getting the best of the breeze right now. A little bit of luck coming to them right when they needed it. They are narrowly managing to lay this bottom mark without losing speed. Meanwhile, Oman Air in a little bit of trouble, that the Swiss round the bottom of the course, still in the lead. Bad news for SAP Extreme Sailing Team fans and fans of Oman Air. The Swiss are holding on to their points advantage. Crucial moment here, Sally, for Oman Air. Red Bull Sailing Team and Element Spark Compass all coming in together.
Yeah, Oman Air needs to pick a clear lane. There they go. They're going to switch sides of the course. They're going to take the risk, sail the opposite gate. And they need to gain a lot here. So they're going to take a risk on this second beat and see how it pans out.
This is exactly what Alinghi didn't want here. Oman Air, it looked like they were lining up to follow the Swiss team in. And no surprise, Sally, Alinghi tacking over.
A lot of covering going on here. Even this light, tricky conditions, it's surprising to see these guys choose their moments when they can actually control the race or when they actually need to go for the pressure.
The homegrown team, Element Spark Compass with Taylor Canfield on the helm, all American crew. They are putting it on for their fans right now in the home waters. They're sailing very nicely. SAP Extreme Sailing Team rounding at the moment. They have got some distance to make up. They need to stay in the fight with Oman Air and Alinghi. And they've got two boats ahead of them, Red Bull Sailing Team and Element Spark Compass, before they can even think about getting into the battle for that first place. And it looks like we're getting some nice breeze at the moment on the far side of the course.
Finally, a little acceleration in the pressure. It might just be a puff. I like the left now as we're looking upwind, maybe a little bit stronger pressure, but to me, the bottom of that course was all about the angles, and the angles are changing quite a bit out here.
Well, Oman Air have tacked back over. Alinghi, well, I would say that's loose cover to me. I mean, they're on the same side of the course as Oman Air, but they're not blocking their breeze. And they're in good wind. The Swiss now tacking. They are tucked up right next to the harbour wall, so they've gone about as far onto the right-hand side of the course as they can. Now tacking back over. You can see Oman Air underneath their jib at the moment. The Omani boat with a bit of room. Let's see what they can do with that power. Certainly Arno Sarafakis, he looks like he's reading the breeze well today.
I would agree. He's really lining it up for the puffs, tacking right before the pressure, so when they put the bow on to accelerate the bow, the boat actually does accelerate and really popping a hull without having to stay too much weight to leeward, and now they're actually hiking at moments.
Oman Air on starboard at the moment, but they lose a boat. Element Spark Compass cross ahead of Oman Air. So, I mean, we could put that down to what happened at the bottom of the course. Element Spark Compass managed to go around the mark that they wanted to. Oman Air had to be defensive. Now, Oman Air bouncing all the way over to the far side of the course, hoping that's where the breeze is going to be, and not wanting to go too far. They've tacked over, and they've tacked right on the face of Adam Minoprio and SAP Extreme Sailing Team.
The game might be changing here a little bit. You know, Phil Robertson and Oman Air might realize that Alinghi just has the control in this race, and he's not willing to give up any points to SAP Extreme and really controlling the race looking backwards.
Well, the old America's Cup yacht in the background. If you think you know what America's Cup yacht that is, do put it in the comments. We were having some debate about it here. We're not 100% certain. We're going to keep our eyes on the GC32s for the moment because there's another key cross coming in here. Oman Air lost out to Element Spark Compass. Now Roman Agara and Red Bull is coming in on starboard. Oman Air having to bear away. It looks to be a little bit of a late bear away, but with a hull flying out of the water, it does make that maneuver a little bit easier.
Really happy here now? No. Well, we never would have got a leave out there, mate.
A little bit happier here now. Phil Robertson on board Oman Air.
Yeah. We're crossing. Trim.
Can Oman Air get the cross back on Element Spark Compass? Element Spark Compass on starboard and Oman Air crossing. Not by much. I don't know about you, Sally, but it looked to me like Oman Air were having to keep the bows quite high there, and they lost a lot of speed. Both hulls in the water. Element Spark Compass tacking, ducking, building speed. Well, it looked like it was going to be the battle for first and second and then the rest of the group, but Oman Air have slipped back into the rest of the field. We have got Alinghi a long way out as Oman Air tacks once again close to that shore side with the Extreme Sailing Series Village in the background with all the crowds. They head their way back over in a group of four boats, and we've got two languishing behind, Ineos Rebels UK and Team Mexico. Well, Alinghi hit the ley line. This is going to be the last rounding before the reach into the finish, that single yellow mark. And Alinghi are a long way ahead at this point. As you say, a little bit of a change for Oman Air to realize that they lost this battle. The Swiss put in a great display. Didn't win the start, didn't get the strongest acceleration off the line, but read the breeze well. And you're thinking about what skills you're going to need for a day like today. It's these skills that we're seeing Arno Sarafakis bring to the fore yet again. If you're fans of Oman Air and you're fans of SAB Extreme Sailing Team, you should be worried about what the Swiss are doing here in San Diego. A great result here for Red Bull. Round in second place. Roman Agara needed to turn it on the final day. Good start.
Really good start, and it's nice to see them finishing here in second place as they had one of the first place starts. Basically, I think the middle of this course is really, really tricky, and there's a bit of snakes and ladders, and it was nice to see them pull through in this top mark.
Well, next few boats coming round here. SAP Extreme Sailing Team rounding in third place. Oman Air have lost so much on this upwind leg. SAP Extreme Sailing Team will finish in third place, and that's a strong finish for them. Element Spark Compass also coming in. Sally, I might have talked a little bit too soon here because it doesn't look to me like they're laying this finish. One or two maneuvers still to go. SAP Extreme Sailing Team, they have got Element Spark Compass on their hip, but no problem for Alinghi. They are going to jibe here and come across the line. It's a slow jibe. It's a drift through the line, but I don't think there's any real concern for Arno Sarafakis. But I tell you what, as I say that, Arno Sarafakis just looking over. Red Bull Sailing Team coming through with pace, but rewarding there for Alinghi. They came very high out of that jive. They knew they needed to build speed. Alinghi take the win in race 16. That's going to see them pushing their points gap even further as they hold on to the top spot here in San Diego. Red Bull sailing team come across the line in second place. Very strong finish for Romain Nogara after a very good start. And then in third place, SAP Extreme Sailing Team. That's good damage limitation there. They were looking at a poor result in this race in the early stages.
That's right, coming last off the starting line with a shocking acceleration or attempted acceleration from that start. To come back in a solid third place, they have to be happy with the minimizing the damage that could have happened.
Well, as SAP Extreme Sailing Team cross over the line. Next two boats are coming in. I'm just waiting to see how close they come in here. Element Spark Compass coming through. They bounce off the wall. Omar and Air to their windward side. These two boats are only boat lengths from the finish line. Omar and Air has the breeze in their sails. Taylor Canfield on Element Spark Compass. He's sailing low. He's going dead downwind. He's drifting it across the finish line. He's hoping that momentum will do the work, and it does. Element Spark Compass managed to finish ahead of Omar and Air. Well, going into today, Oman Air were 5 points behind Alinghi. But after that result, it's going to be a lot bigger.
What a shame. I mean, Oman Air really had all to play for that first run. They were really gaining a ton. They gained back from a tough start. And then I think the luck just didn't go their way at the top. And it was almost like they were pushing the limits too hard. Right. Made one wrong choice and boom, a few places.
Oh, the whole left-hand side has the tide. Come over here, boys, in the shade. Hey?
All team chase.
Yeah, we shouldn't even bother. In hindsight, I would have gone further in here on the first one and just flag Alinghi. If they hit us, whatever. And then I think there's a little more pressure. We came a little further. Tried to take that even further again out to that side. Minimize it a bit. And we hit, when we hit SAP, my probably ideal line was another 15 seconds, I reckon. And then again, I said, my best line's to tack here and go back. And you were like, oh, really? And then I think the next time was the intersection, like that was 10, 20 seconds later. And then we just obviously had to dip and we were
I was thinking communicate quick enough, but I wanted to go back for Red Bull.
I kind of feel I'm getting your decisions way too late all the time. So let's try and preempt things a little bit earlier. And don't be afraid of tacking. I think that scares us quite a lot to tack, but it's shifty and it's puffy.
All right, mate, I think we leave it there. Big pressure lines that are moving across the
Sally, a little bit of a treat here to hear some of the words from the debrief coming off from Oman Air. Just before we talk about some of the things that we're talking about, let's have a look at the scores, the confirmation of the points being awarded here, because we know this is going to be crucial for Swiss fans. Alinghi taking the maximum 12 points. Oman Air down in fifth, getting 8. Let's see how that has affected the overall standings now that we have completed 16 races. Well, Alinghi on 174, and then Oman Air 9 points behind now in second place. The big worry for Oman Air is as Alinghi push a little further ahead, SAP Extreme Sailing Team in third place and now only 1 point behind. And that is going to get very interesting as these races continue. Well, we can hear from the winning skipper right now, Arno Sarafagas on Alinghi. Arno, so far, this is going just the way you would have wanted it.
Yes, for sure, it's looking pretty good our way right now, but it's a long day, and I think they will fight back, so we need to stay focused and look for the next race.
It seems to us here in the commentary box that you are able to see the wind on the course when everybody else can't. Is it easy to see where you need to go, or is there a bit of a gamble?
You know, when you're ahead, it's much easier than in the fleet, and sometimes you have some luck, and I think it's pretty good on the way today, yeah.
Well, congratulations to you and your team. Keep pushing hard. This is a thrilling race. Right, Sally, let's try and get into what we heard there from Oman Air, because not often do you get to hear, listen in, unpack, and try and get a little bit of a sense of what happened. They didn't have the race that they wanted. I mean, what stood out for you?
I think the specifics of hearing Phil just pick apart the exact places where they tacked weren't really satisfactory for him. He wanted some decisions a bit earlier, more discussion about what they were feeling, and a few decisions early on in that first beat that they would take back to maximize their gains. I mean, what a treat that was to hear the entire debrief from a skipper who really knows what he wants.
And I thought very interesting to hear the tone that the crew were talking. You know, there wasn't a lot of finger pointing. There wasn't a lot of you did that, that lost us this. It was a case of, you know, moving forward. I'd really like it if you could talk to me a little earlier. Lots of nods, lots of moving forward. Very, very, very impressive to hear such a professional team. And we know that this is such a professional team. Not only are they sailing well on the GC32, but Oman Air and Oman Sail is all about building the next generation of sailors in Oman, not least Nasser Al-Mashri on board Oman Air and making a big name for himself in his home country.
My name is Nasser Salman Mashari. I'm from Oman. I live in Muscat. I'm born in Muscat. I've got a family here in Muscat, 8 brothers and 3 sisters, and we are very close to each other. I get very, very big support from them, and I'm happy for that. I'm traveling a lot with Oman Air and Oman Sail as well, so I miss home a lot. People here and culture, I love the culture in my home country, so still missing it there, but when we're going traveling around, we take this culture back to the other countries, and then we show them how we are. I'm not doing it for myself only, I do it for Oman, for His Majesty, for people, you know, and to me this place, this sand of Oman is most dear than anything else in the world. I would like the rest of the world to see how we are live here in Oman with a beautiful culture and a beautiful nature. When people ask me, Nasser, I mean, what you do, when I tell them sailing, they was so shocked about sailing this and what's exactly. By now, I mean, people, they're not surprised because sailing coming more popular in Oman. And people now, they like to sail a lot. And the young generation, they're pushing hard. And I'm so happy and proud to be support them. And I'm sure we'll have a great future for sailing.
Nasser Al-Mashri on board Oman Air. And as we were saying, Sally, very interesting to hear from that team, debriefing the race, looking back, learning what can be learned from the racing. So let's do it ourselves. Let's have a little bit of a look at how the race unfolded play by play. I mean, we knew that it was going to be pretty light out there, but there was plenty of power. We did see some holes flying, and it was pretty crucial to find yourself in that breeze.
It was crucial to find your lane, crucial to not get stuck into maybe a really big duck there, like Red Bull Sailing, having a tough lane with Element Sports Compass. You know, it's a tricky place to be sailing. The boats that are winning the race are holding their own.
And as you say, actually, there was a lot of ducking. There was a lot of boats sort of going, no, this is a tactical game. You've got to give a little to get quite a bit back.
You do. And, you know, one of the things that stood out from Phil Robertson there in his debrief was tacking. We seem to be afraid of tacking, and we can't be. We got to put in more tacks when we think it's appropriate, something we see a Lingi doing without even blinking an eye.
And so, Chris, the tacks of the Swiss team, the maneuvers of them, but also a very strong performance from the home boat, Element Spark Compass. It would be wrong to assume that this boat is going to be able to jump into the Extreme Sailing Series and sail at the level that they want to, the fans want to, and we want them to. But individual performances, every opportunity to feel proud.
It's super crucial for them to be improving every race, right? It's really important for the series. It's important for their next step in these boats in this Extreme Sailing Series. And that's what we're seeing them doing. We're seeing their little tricks in the speed, the maneuvers, and how they're racing against the other boats.
And Lingi, in that race, I mean, they did pretty much dominant, didn't they? They sailed out, they got clear, they managed to keep themselves out of trouble. There were a few times we saw Oman Air managing to put a little bit of pressure on them, certainly at the bottom of the first lap. But it was this moment here that Oman Air had to break free. That put Element Spark Compass in the hunt. And Lingi, I'm sure, were very pleased to see these boats scrapping it out, because once you're out in front, nothing better when your rivals lock horns and start distracting each other.
And you heard Arno say it's a little bit easier when you're out in front, and that is true. You look a lot smarter, but they all have something going for them. I feel like they're just a little bit quicker in this condition, and it's making their tactics look like bliss.
Well, that was the first of the big ducks for Oman Air, and sadly for them, it just kept bouncing them onto the back foot on the second half of that long upwind leg. And it meant that Alinghi and the Swiss team rounding that single yellow mark, the final turning mark, so far into the lead that they could take things pretty easily. But potentially they took things a little bit too easily, because just coming into the finish, Red Bull sailing team got hot on their heels. Alinghi still managed to hold on for the win. But Red Bull sailing team reminding Arno Sarafagas that I'll let you win, but I won't let you win easy. I'm going to keep pushing you all the way to the line. A great race, and hopefully with the breeze, we're going to get even more racing to come here in San Diego. Well, the breeze at the moment, the shot down the racetrack at the moment, Sally. I mean, we've been talking so much about the breeze the last 2 days. It's not as strong as we would like. It does put a lot of pressure on these sailors, but it does make the racing pretty interesting.
It does. We see a lot of snakes and ladders, a lot of crossing, a lot of ducking. Some really in-the-moment decisions for these tacticians and these helmsmen have to connect their thoughts on what the boat is feeling and what might happen next.
And it's a hard work for John Craig and the race control team as well. I mean, we talk about how difficult it is for the skippers. This is the man here who has to set the course for the breeze.
7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, mark.
Two minutes to go for the start of race 17. John Craig enjoying a little bit of shade. I'm very happy to see they've got some shade on that race control boat. It's a beautiful day here on the shore. If you're out in San Diego watching the racing on the shoreline with a refreshment in the cool breeze, in the shade, it's certainly very nice in the commentary box. Hard work if you are on the water, but you are close enough to the fans here that you can hear them enjoying themselves, cheering you on. So certainly a reward for all your efforts. But Sally, I mean, it's interesting to see just how close they are pushing towards that harbor wall, because it almost looks like it's a little bit light down there. It almost looks like there's this hint of current, maybe. Well, one thing's for sure, they do like to bounce as close off that wall as possible.
They do, and the wall goes fairly straight down, but these boards do carry a lot of depth in them, so we don't want to get so close to it that they're obviously going to tap the rocks. But there is a little bit of maybe deceleration, a bit of less friction as the wind is trying to pass the wall. Different than what we saw yesterday. We saw more acceleration against the wall. We've seen some puffs out there on the far left. I wonder if we're going to see more boats starting on starboard this race.
Well, the boats are lining up to the start. Oman Air at the moment very close to the line with 35 seconds to go. That is the layout for the first leg up to the windward gate. We can expect them to be pushing very close into that harbor wall. But for right now, 25 seconds to go, let's see about that final little bit of positioning. Oman Air right now close to the line. Element Spark Compass furthest out to the left as Oman Air peels their way over onto starboard. They had to do it, really. The code zero comes out. They're on starboard. Everyone else around them is on port. This could be a very strong start coming off the pin end here for Oman Air if they can nail the time. It's the black boy just in front of them. And as the gun fires, Phil Robinson. Oman Air has been called over the line. It was so close, maybe half a meter, but the Omani boat over the line. After the hardship of the last race, they're going to start race 17 on the back foot.
What a shame. They really had the acceleration. You can see Phil was just wiggling the boat, trying to slow it down, so they felt like they were early. They had to go when they did, but what a mistake. You're the only boat starting on starboard, and you're over the line.
Well, let's not forget that we did see Oman Air and SAP Extreme Sailing Team in sixth, in seventh, at the back of the field in the opening stages of the last race. SAP Extreme Sailing Team still managed to finish third. And I'm sure that Oman Air is going to be pushing pretty hard. Meanwhile, though, in the lead right now, SAP Extreme Sailing Team, Alinghi, and Red Bull Sailing Team. Red Bull Sailing Team, furthest boat on the left. One of the only, the few boats to head out to the left-hand side. You can see from the 3D graphics just how close the action is to that harbor wall. That definitely seems to be where the consistency in the breeze is.
I agree, and we'll see Alinghi come out of this wall with attack pretty soon, and they think it's going to be the angle that's key that comes across. They're sailing fairly wide angles going upwind in this light air, and if they have a little lift off the shoreline, it's a gainer.
Well, on board Alinghi at the moment, and they are crossing 1, 2, 3, 4 boats at the moment. They've got SAP Extreme Sailing Team out of shot on the same tack just in front of them. That's a nice start right now. Now let's not forget here, Alinghi are 10 points clear of SAP Extreme Sailing Team, 9 points clear of Oman Air. Oman Air at this stage of the race, what I was going to say, Oman Air at this stage of the race not doing very well, but they've closed up a bit of distance.
They have. They're one tack behind, let's not forget. But because they're sort of in the middle of the course more, they should be able to have a clear lane once they reach that wall as everybody else is forced to go back across the middle.
Oh, they managed to cross Element Spark Compass. It looked like a tight cross to me. It looked like Taylor Canfield just had to put the bow down. He looked behind. Almost wondering whether there was going to be a protest flag for that. Team Mexico. They're still ahead of the Omani boat, on better form in this race at the moment. And we are going, still going, all the way over to the harbour wall. They are pushing it right the way to the limit. Something that we've seen from all the teams here.
Wait, guys, wait up. I'm pressing, and we're already flying a hull. Stand by. 2, 1.
Just thinking there, Sally, as we can hear Phil Robertson, the skipper on board Oman Air, talking. I was just thinking, keep your cool. Don't let it boil over yet.
But it gives you an idea of the details of sailing these boats, even in this light air. As soon as the helmsman feels a little bit of power, they need that body weight to be out. If they go in early to get ready for the tack, the boat just heels up and they lose that speed.
SAP Extreme Sailing Team, this is the boat in the middle of the course right now. Look at what is happening. SAP Extreme Sailing Team were in the battle for first place, but it's Oman Air right now that it's in first. This could be a confidence boost just when they need it. SAP Extreme Sailing Team are now on the right-hand side of your picture. Look at Oman Air on the left.
You just need a little pressure to hold here to cross the middle. We've seen a lot of dead zones in the pressure right straight down from these gates, and the corners have been paying off in the end. So we'll see if Oman Air can just carry it all the way across.
SAP Extreme Sailing Team. Attack for SAP Extreme Sailing Team and Adam Manoprio. This is going to be crucial. They are not quite on the ley line unless they get a good bit of pressure or a good shift. Attacking over, and they're going to have Team Mexico coming pretty close. It looks like SAP Extreme Sailing Team just crossing ahead of Team Mexico, not by much. Oman Air look good for this cross here, plus they're on starboard.
They just have one tack to go to make it to these gates. Almost like a full fleet inversion here. We see Alinghi now at the bottom of the scoreboard, behind everybody, maybe not able to find their clean lane, not able to just have that little bit of luck with the pressure and the angle.
Oman Air going for a very crucial tack. Now, SAP Extreme Sailing Team have added some height to their line, and it looked to me like they were maybe sailing a little bit low here, almost to trick Oman Air that was the angle they were on. Now they come high.
So high mode, weight down.
Oman Air calling a high mode. Ineos Rebels UK trying to get into the mix, but it's going to be these two teams battling it out for the top spot as we go on board with Oman Air. A little bit of trimming on the foil. Ineos approaching in the background underneath the jib, but it's going to be too little, too late. Oman Air leading at the top of the course. Here. You would not have called that from the line. This was the boat that had arguably the best start, but just one split second too early. That meant they had to begin behind everybody else. Ineos Rebels UK round in third place with SAP Extreme Sailing Team splitting and rounding in second. I don't think here, Sally, SAP Extreme Sailing Team, I'd expect them to be going around in this picture right now. Yeah, they've obviously tacked off. I don't think they wanted to.
That's correct. I don't think they wanted to. I think they had to for a bit of clear air. They were sailing that high mode, trying to push Oman Air into an early tack into the gates. They're going for a split. They sailed that side of the course coming upwind. Maybe they're just going to try to make it work, but I agree. I think they wanted to follow the pack over to this side of the course.
Element Spark Compass at the top of the course, and we are staying at the moment with the boat still to round because Alinghi in last place is the one at the top of the leaderboard, not just for San Diego, but also for the Extreme Sailing Series 2008. So this is the boat that has been performing so well here in San Diego, and it seems to have unraveled on a single upwind beat. They got the breeze at the moment. Windward hull flying. Let's see what the Swiss can do by the time we get down to the bottom of the course. They've got the wind right now, but just look at the distance that they need to make up. Oman Air, they've lost out in the early stage of this run. As we said, SAP Extreme Sailing Team, they were forced to split. And that far side looks quite good for SAP Extreme Sailing Team. Oman Air, they've got a good few boats on their breeze.
I think it's going to come down to angle once again at this bottom mark. I think SAP Extreme are sailing a header, and that's a good thing going downwind. They're sailing a lower angle straight to the marks, and Oman Air is just trying to come across, and probably we'll see them jibe in front and try to defend their lead.
Well, it is neck and neck at the moment on the computer. Oman Air just managing to win back the lead, pulling it up to 10 meters. SAP Extreme Sailing Team, they're losing out here, and Oman Air rolling into a jibe. That goes to show that Phil Robinson is worried about Adam Inoprio.
That's right, and it's about being on the long jibe here, in pressure. You can't sail the lift going downwind too long, or you're just going to lose the game.
SAP Extreme Sailing Team have the speed edge over the Omani boat at the moment. We'd expect that coming out from the maneuvers.
I can't hear you. Really, copy? Coming up half here.
Deep. Cool,
Phil. I'm on lay for right now. Still happy left, are you? Stand by. 3, 2, 1, going.
Oman Air lining up for a left-hand turn of the two white gates. SAP Extreme Sailing Team simultaneously jibing on top of them. A lot of aggression at the bottom of the track.
A lot of aggression and great spot for SAP. I think if Oman Air goes really to the left, SAP can go right. If Oman Air goes right, then they can split to the left. It's not a bad spot.
Oman Air sailing high. They were laying that bottom gate, but they are sailing high right now. SAP Extreme Sailing Team.
Max on that board.
Adam Inoprio bearing her away.
Going straight, going
round
straight.
Round the bows of Oman Air.
Yes. Yes. Oh, bow's coming.
SAP Extreme Sailing Team round in first place. Oman Air coming through, just getting a few drips and drabs of the atmosphere on board Oman Air. Sally, Phil Robinson, he's holding on tight here. You can feel how his nerves are just quivering on the edge.
It sure feels like it, and it feels like he's starting to question a little bit the calls from the crew, which means it's, you know, the decisions aren't coming super quick and crisp. I mean, given the conditions out there, I wouldn't expect anything different, but I wonder what it's like aboard SAP, where they're just a bit more comfortable to roll. What a great move they had into their leeward mark, and they're keeping it a little simpler.
Well, look at what's happening behind them. This is very important. What happens with this boat right here, the Swiss team, Alinghi. They rounded in seventh place. It's going to be a slow rounding as they have to put the jibe in right next to the mark, but they've got the inside turn and they might be able to get a decent lane here. Element Spark Compass pushing them high, and I think Taylor Canfield will be rolling into attack fairly soon. He's taken it high for Element Spark Compass to try and get a little bit of a lane, but he just blew all speed. He'll be pleased to see Alinghi tacking off. Oman Air will not be happy to see the Swiss team rounding in a position that we could see develop into a strong score.
It really feels like they have the capability to kind of climb back into the group. If they can have a halfway decent beat here, I think they can kind of basically play the averages and not burn so many points on the finish line.
Positions in this race changing. Second by second, SAP Extreme Sailing Team and Oman Air. One small shift to the left. SAP Extreme Sailing Team are going to get into the lead. A little bit of a shift to the right, as we are seeing now, and Oman Air starts to get the gains. There you can see the wall in front of them, Ineos Rebels UK. They'll be bouncing off it first. Then it'll be Oman Air. Following Oman Air is Alinghi, at the moment. And Alinghi don't need to finish this race in top form. They can allow Oman Air to get a good result as long as they just limit the damage.
I would agree. Because of the previous race, they put a few more points on Oman Air and SAP, and so now they can sail in the middle of the group and be okay for the next few races. It's not their target for sure, but they'll be looking to pick off one or two boats instead of having to gain the whole fleet in one shot.
Well, this is the boat that's coming over from the far side of the course, and they put Oman Air in pressure on the downwind section, but Oman Air get the lead back and get it back with the strong, strong split. 50, maybe 60 meters the lead for Oman Air on that cross. Absolutely superb work. We've talked about Phil Robertson just feeling a little bit under pressure in this race. What you want to hear if you're fans from Oman Air is that little bit of confidence in his voice. It's not there yet.
It's not there, but you know, he's still finding his groove. It's a day to keep questioning everything. And if you're not questioning it, you're probably being too satisfied and you're probably gonna lose inches around the course. We've seen a lot of lead changes, so he can't start getting upset over one little pass here and there. And I think this beat showed that he's got his groove back.
Well, he'll be very pleased with the view that he's got right now because he has not got SAP Extreme Sailing Team anywhere near him. Adam Inoprio putting the boat through attack. Even in the light wind, such hard physical work. Adam Rinoprio coming onto the windward side, helming the boat on the perfect angle to get the acceleration. Meanwhile, in the lead, Oman Air have tacked over their last tack of this race. Now they just need to build the speed round the yellow mark, just creeping into shot, and then the very short downwind to the finish.
Let's keep the weight down. Weight down here, boys.
Oman Air around the top, and there is no one close enough to them to cause them any real problems. And crucially, unlike in the last race, they are laying the finish.
Yeah, really nice angle here. I think they shortened up the actual beat on the course so the boats can have more of a reaching angle into the finish, more of our standard situation.
Oman Air coming into the finish. They are in first place. The eyes are behind. They're looking at their competition. And they can see that their hard work is paying off. This is exactly the result that this boat needed, not only from the result from the last race, but also from the start they had. Race 17 and a victory for Oman Air, a crucial confidence builder. Well, behind them, at the top of the course, we've got Ineos Rebels UK, SAP Extreme Sailing Team, and now Red Bull Sailing Team coming in as well. Red Bull Sailing Team coming in. They're having to put the bows up high as SAP Extreme Sailing Team tacking late off the mark. They have got rights with them, though, as SAP Extreme Sailing Team. Red Bull Sailing Team have got pace, and they're rounding straight over the top of them. So good news, further good news for Oman Air. Point between them and SAP Extreme Sailing Team. Nice tack and bear away from Ineos Rebels UK, and they are in a strong position here. We could see the British rolling SAP Extreme Sailing Team. Red Bull Sailing Team, they are laying this finish. SAP Extreme Sailing Team are having to sail high. No such problems for Roman Agara on board Red Bull Sailing Team. Second place for Roman Agara. He needs strong finishes. He did well in the last race, well in this one. Roman Agara could be a feature on the podium here in San Diego. Next to come through is SAP Extreme Sailing Team holding off the charge of Ineos Rebels UK. Adam Rinoprio doing well to stay into the fight. The British come through in fourth place. And then Sally, well, let's talk about the Swiss. Alinghi now coming through the finish line. I just heard over the radio that Alinghi got a penalty on that second upwind leg. We're not sure what it was. You talk about confidence boost for Oman Air. What does this do for Alinghi?
I think this might just reset Alinghi a little bit, just into, like, let's make sure we really tick our boxes here. They had a good start. They obviously made some critical and maybe in hindsight wrong decisions on that first beat. But there's also some element that they don't have control of here, which is this, these little lines of pressure coming down the course, and they have to really play the game of percentages and lining themselves up for the big ones. And I think they probably did, and they just got a bit unlucky in this middle of the course.
Two more teams to come into the finish. Team Mexico managing to push the home boat.
We need to get down in seventh. Guest exchange, and we need to get you guys down here as quick as we can to make our TV window.
Taylor Canfield on Element Spark Compass. It's difficult, isn't it? Because you're here as a wildcard team. You can't fool yourself to think that you're going to perform at your best on a boat that is a little bit new. Maybe not for Taylor Canfield, who sailed on the GC32 before, but certainly for his team. But like any racer, you want to win.
That's right. Any racer wants to be out there to win. The hardest part is figuring out what to do when you're not winning. That's the whole key to this level of sailing. It's also about the hours in the boat. You know, these guys don't have as many hours together as a team. I would imagine if we had the mics on Taylor today, the communication would be a little bit chunky.
Well, one boat that we did get the communication on was Oman Air, and we can talk to that team now. We have got Phil Robertson, the skipper of Oman Air. I mean, Phil, for your fans watching Oman Air right now, it is a roller coaster ride. First of all, that start, that looked hard.
Yeah, I guess roller coasters are quite exciting, so they're probably having a good time then. We're obviously OCS just got a bit of a puff on the gun and just pulled the trigger a little early for that much pressure, and OCS came back, and then pretty much the beat just lined itself up for us from there, so it's quite nice actually to have that sort of swing your way, I guess, for once. So luck was on our side then, and we managed to play it smartly after that. So, yeah, good race.
A good race, and I've got to say, you did a great job very quickly to get yourself back into the hunt. This will help close those scores a little bit between you and Alinghi, but it certainly looks like between yourself, SAP Extreme Sailing Team, and the Swiss, it's going to come down to a really good show for the final race.
Yeah, well, we hope so. We hope we can put on a good show, and it's going to be close, so we're going to go out and work pretty hard.
All right, well, good luck, and keep it up. Let's have a look at the standings after 17 races, now that the scores have been confirmed. Alinghi, 182 points. Oman Air now back to 5 points. And it seems to be that Alinghi and Oman Air just are glued to this 5-point differential. That was the points difference that we went into day three. That's where we was when we went into day four. Now we're back to it. SAP Extreme Sailing Team in third. They fall a little bit further back. Now it's 3 points between them and Oman Air. Red Bull Sailing Team closing down that distance to the podium, but they still have got to do something strong. I mean, Roman Agara needs to win a race and needs these top three teams to really come in last place.
Yeah, he kind of has a big mountain to climb, but we have seen some consistency here from them and their team today on the Red Bull Sailing Team. 2 second places, it's kind of a really good start. If they can get second all day, the consistency might pay off.
Well, let's have a little look at how that last race unfolded. I mean, the big thing here, Sally, is that start, Oman Air, over the line. I mean, it must have been half a meter.
It looked like, yeah, a big portion of the hulls were over. Like Phil said, they just got a puff there. They couldn't do anything with it. They didn't have enough distance away from the line. Just kind of too risky for them in the situation that they need, but it opened the doors for them to have a clear lane up the middle of the beat.
And they didn't wait around. It was a pretty quick turn. They knew that they were over, weren't surprised, and got straight into the recovery. And it was a recovery that worked very well for them, because I don't know about yourself, but as the racing unfolded, Red Bull Sailing Team pushing their way to the lead, Alinghi working hard there. It was incredible to see Oman Air coming through as quickly as they did.
It goes to show the level of sailors that we have here. The group is super intense, and they're all fighting for their inches out there. And if you give somebody even a few clean lanes and their own pressure from the back of the group, they can work their way through the middle.
But again, we did hear Phil Robertson talking on Oman Air about joining up the dots, not being afraid to put the tacks in. who needs breeze here to make these races exciting? We had snakes and ladders. You had to tack, you had to be aggressive, and you had to be slick in your sailing.
A lot of lead changes, and that's kind of the exciting part for these guys, to see how they're reacting when boats are passing them and what moves are they focusing on to actually get themselves back in the game.
Another very crucial cross for Oman Air in the later stages of this race. You can see the difference in speed, the confidence that you must need as a helmsman, as a tactician, to call attack after you've just spent, what, 20, 25 seconds building that pace. You know you're going to burn it all away.
Yeah, super tricky for the tacticians today, trying to find those moments to make a clean tack. When it lines up, and that makes their job quite easy. The course, I think, has gotten a little bit shorter, but it's quite narrow, so they're forced into at least 2 to 3 tacks per beat.
Light winds, difficult on the way upwind, difficult on the way down. Ineos Rebels UK performing a little bit better than what we saw from them yesterday in San Diego. The British team not on their best form, and crucially as well, not on their best form for Alinghi. That was a team that desperately wanted to keep up a very strong pace that they did out there. But sadly, it wasn't to be on this race. Oman Air putting in a fantastic display and proving to themselves they don't need to be the boat that wins the start. They don't need to be the boat that gets that early lead. They can make their way through the fleet. SAP Extreme Sailing Team also managing to stay into the fight at the moment. And this is a crew that, I mean, from last year in the Extreme Sailing Series, they have come through and punched well above their weight. Adam Onoprio on board set the standard for the tactical racing that we are seeing playing out here, and of course, playing out today. And they've got even more big names to come through on SAP Extreme Sailing Team. We have got the young gun, the rising star, Julius Hellstrom on board, making a big name for himself and proving to be a very worthy member of that team.
I grew up on an island in Stockholm Archipelago, and go for a morning run and stuff. You can go say hello to the cows, and yeah, it's pretty cool. I started sailing when I was 5 years old. It was my first race in this small regatta around Stockholm. When I was younger, I grew up playing a lot of ice hockey. Mainly, it's a really good way to work out. It's really awesome, and Sweden is a perfect place for that. Gets you kind of a good shape for any other sport you want to do. My job is to be a second-hand help to the other boys, pulling the ropes, being as strong as I can. Yeah, the boys, they think I eat a lot of food, and especially potatoes, so the garbage man eat all the food. That's my...
We're really struggling to feed him. He's an eating machine, you know. We've got probably one of the strongest guys in the whole fleet here, so it's good having Jules on there, but we've got to feed him.
Sure, that's everything. I mean, you spent your whole year trying to win a thing, and to win the Extreme Sailing Series would be a big, big step in my career and the boys' career. And the team is capable of doing it again.
Four, three, two, one, mark. 1 minute.
Oh, we're straight back into the action here. Inside of 1 minute, the pre-start for race 18. Sally, let's just take a moment to celebrate here, because earlier on today we were thinking we might not get any races in.
I agree, and now we're feeling a little bit of pressure actually on our backs here in the commentary booth, a little bit of cooler air, and I think we're quite pleased to see that the pressure is actually still filled all the way across the course.
And it almost feels like the recipe here for the Extreme Sailing Series is either 25 knots where these GC32s rip around, or light winds, patchy, where we get these tactical battles.
Always a challenge here on the Extreme Sailing Series.
20 seconds to go. Oman Air need to get another one. They need to keep up this assault on the scorecard of Alinghi and keep SAP Extreme Sailing Team at bay. Yeah. Let's see how it is they are approaching this line. Well, yet again, coming into the line on starboard, this time with SAP Extreme Sailing Team. Alinghi lining up on port. So far, it looks good for those boats on port. Element Spark Compass coming off well with pace on port. Oman Air, they are going to be able to cross the fleet here. But are they going to the good side of the course?
To me, it looks like they just hit that line perfectly. Great acceleration and really on the lifted tack, quite a high angle there on starboard.
Well, we were talking about the breeze just a moment ago. What a different story this tells all the crew on the windward side.
Yeah, I think it's going to kind of relief everybody, let the shoulders down. They're going to start to move a bit easier in the boat, not feel so stuck in this light, sticky pressure. Everybody should be able to take it a little bit more in stride.
Not a great start for Red Bull sailing team. They're down in seventh at the moment. We can expect them to build from there, but they had good speed. 10 knots plus off from that line. But this is where the battle is for first place at the moment. Oman Air and SAP Extreme Sailing Team heading off to the left-hand side. Meanwhile, on the other side of the course, Ineos Rebels UK are about to make their tack away from that harbour wall. Alinghi on their side. It's going to put the British team onto starboard tack. So no surprise to see Alinghi tacking out early. Now, normally, we've seen these boats ducking in, wanting to be that boat further in. But as Ineos Rebels UK tack over, Alinghi have already tacked. So could it be that the far side of the course, the side of the course that Oman Air is on, is the one there you want to be?
Might have a little bit more pressure. This might have to do with angle, that there's not much more to be gained in here in the shore. Basically, you saw that image before where there was a little lighter pressure right against the shore, and there's not many more lanes up here. Ineos Rebels UK really took the spot, and it forced Alinghi to go a little bit earlier.
Look at Red Bull sailing team. They were down in seventh place. They started last. They had good speed, but look at what they've done on one single shift. Played that absolutely perfectly. Right now, I don't know if we can get a shot of the 3D graphics, but at the moment, take a look at the track, the white track of Element Spark Compass. It almost looked like they sailed a little bit of a header, sailed again. That means that Ineos Rebels UK that have come out from that far right-hand side as we look downwind, they're also coming out in a bit of a header. Now, what does that mean for the boats that went to the far side? SAP Extreme Sailing Team crossing, and Oman Air well into the lead.
I think that's the first time we've seen the boats start on starboard be actually the correct move all weekend. And I think things are changing a little bit as the afternoon goes on. I guess we're going to see a little, there's a chance, I guess, we see a little left shift.
Now, if you want to read the breeze, who's in the best of it at the moment as we look through the course, watch the windward hulls. We want that to be lifting. We want the crews to be hiking out as well. At the moment for Oman Air, they are just flying that windward hull, not very consistently. Ineos Rebels UK, a little further back in the middle of the track, only just flying that windward hull. Now the gear changes, the breeze goes light.
Really crucial for them to get their weight forward, get the stern out of the water, keeps the bows in, keeps the boat actually a little bit more powered up.
Pressing. Wait up.
Yes, we know that the strong breeze is physical. But this wind right here, when you're stuck between modes, this can be pretty trying on the crew.
It's super trying, and it's really a mental game. You see these guys, they're not actually sitting still on the boat and just staring off into Never Never Land or looking at the sails. They have their heads and their shoulders on this massive swivel. They're looking at any ounce of information from the other boats, anything they can see on the water, anything they see at the top marks coming down that they can read and feed into the boat so they make the best plan ever.
That's a moneymaker. I'm tacking right turn now, and this puff on the... lefty though, the puff coming down. Yeah, so it might be early jibe.
Is it just me, Sally, or are we seeing a slight change in the personality of Phil Robinson?
That's right. Feeling the moneymaker, is that what he said? He's really feeling the mode of the boat, and they're making better decisions. You can see how much more comfortable he's talking to his teammates about the information about where they should be going.
Oman Air. It looks like they're lining up for one more tack at the top. They don't need to do it. They could bear away the opposite mark, but they think they have a handle on where the breeze is on this course. They're lining themselves up for the downwind leg, sailing in close to the shore. Look at the distance they've been able to pull out. As Phil Robinson said, that shift, that last puff, that was the moneymaker. SAP Extreme Sailing Team might not be able to lay that top mark. They are just look like they'll be able to lay that opposite mark. Red Bull Sailing Team, Ineos Rebels UK are fighting out for third place. But there is a big distance here between first and second. SAP Extreme Sailing Team managed to make it round, but they're splitting from Oman Air and sailing down the far side of the course. Next to come through, Red Bull Sailing Team, and crucially here, Sally, attack at the top of the course, showing that Roman Agara, he's putting his money with SAP Extreme Sailing Team.
Very interesting to figure out what shift these guys should be sailing downwind. To me, there's been like three shifts on the upwind, probably meaning there's going to be two shifts on the downwind. And we have a split. Oman Air has chosen to basically sail downwind, left-hand side of the course, closer to shore. SAP Extreme, more offshore. It's going to be all about angles again, I believe.
Red Bull Sailing Team and Ineos Red Bulls UK have caught some lovely gusts at the moment on the far side of the course. Just look at the speed at the moment for Red Bull Sailing Team, 14 knot. This is a Lingi at the moment coming round at the top. They, too, are sailing onto the far side of the course.
Shot of Oman Air, they're parked up, no breeze.
Red Bull Sailing Team, Ineos Red Bulls UK and Lingi, they have all gone to the far side. They've all got breeze. And look at Oman Air, both hulls in the water. Look at the speed, under 10 knots. They have been struggling for the last minute and a half.
Effing.
Now, finally, the breeze arrives. That must have been agony the last few moments for Phil Robertson.
It's not over until it's over. That's the name of the game out here. Those hulls are out there, and sometimes you have to sail from the pressure to the next pressure, but if there's a hole in between, you have to get through it. That's where the patience really comes into play.
Well, it's brought SAP Extreme Sailing Team back into the hunt for first place. Red Bull Sailing Team, they're also in this as well with Ineos Rebels UK. The speed's on the top left-hand side. Got to give it to Red Bull Sailing Team. They've consistently been one of the fastest boats on the fleet. SAP Extreme Sailing Team, sailing in close to the wall. You can see Adam Manoprio looking around, trying to judge up where the breeze is, where the marks are. Where's the perfect spot to jibe?
Still one right.
A Red Bull Sailing Team sailing very nicely right now. Interesting that they are putting their weight all the way down, including Roman Agara, trying to fly that windward hull.
And I think that's an effort to have a choice to lay this left-hand turn, which Oman Air is just turning right now. If, you know, Red Bull Sailing Team can lay it, then they have a choice depending on what happens with SAP Extreme.
Well, Oman Air have survived the battle for first place for now. SAP Extreme Sailing Team have got it all on with Red Bull Sailing Team. SAP Extreme Sailing Team on starboard. They're going for the jibe. Red Bull Sailing Team going on the inside, and I'm not sure they've got room in there. Roman Agara realizing it. He's had to put in a massive handbrake turn. Adam Manoprio knows exactly how to put you onto the back foot on these leeward marks.
That's right, the power of leading at somebody around the same mark as you, that's just it. They have to put on the brakes. Red Bull Sailing Team did not have room in there. They had to completely stop the boat. They would have been much better off jabbing away to the other gate.
Very difficult moment there for Red Bull Sailing Team, but they have closed up this distance, and if they can manage to hold on to that lane, they will be able to hold on to third. Lingi coming round at the moment. They're going to be rounding in fifth place. If they can hold back Team Mexico, this is further good news for SAP Extreme Sailing Team, and even better news for Oman Air. Well, just getting snippets of the conversation between Phil Robertson and Pete Greenhouse. And what you're looking for in this situation here, Sally, correct me if I'm wrong, but you know, when you ask your tactician what's the plan, you want it confident, you want it clear, you want it precise. You don't ever want to hear it, look, I don't know.
Yeah. Or maybe this way, or maybe that way. No, you saw Pete's arm be like, we want to go this way. This is the long tack, I'm sure he was saying. There's good pressure out here. We go until we, you know, until we see some sort of change.
SAP Extreme Sailing Team, now they're close to the shore. They have still got quite a bit of leverage here on Oman Air. On a course where we know the breeze is very difficult to predict, Oman Air have got a tough decision right now. They've got a Lingi sailing over to the far side of the track. Not in a great position. They've got SAP Extreme on the other side of the track. Pretty difficult to cover two boats on either side of the course.
I think they just have to go with what's in their gut right now. Reading the breeze, they're still looking out onto the water. There's still a few big holes as we get up close to this gate, this top gate, and or this last turning mark, and they're just going to have to basically pick their best line.
Oman Air, if the breeze holds, they're coming up to the ley line. And they go for it. Now they've tacked just underneath this ley line, and there is only one final windward mark to go, a single buoy, and then the short downwind into the finish. Light winds, Every little ounce of effort needed. Big pulls, big grind, big work from the crew. It's a good tack. They've got themselves on a nice little bit of pressure at the moment. Well, it looks good for Oman Air with SAP Extreme Sailing Team. It looks even better when you compare it to Alinghi. Ineos Rebels UK right now are in third place. They've got Red Bull Sailing Team out to their far side. Alinghi on their hip, but don't be fooled by that camera angle. Ineos Rebels UK should still be ahead of the Swiss boat. And that extra position, we see Alinghi slip down. There's going to be more points lost for Arno Sarafaga. So even though Alinghi are not going to be able to win from this position, they're going to see Oman Air taking the win. It's imperative for the Swiss to try and limit the damage by overtaking as many boats as they can. Oman Air, final tack completed. Onto the last reach, onto the last downwind. It looks like the ley line should be able to get them into the finish. Lovely little puff there for Oman Air. Windward hull flying. You can see the crew just gulping in the air right now. Some tired muscles, some tired lungs, but Oman Air, another fantastic performance on the final day here in San Diego. Race 18 and the maximum of 12 points. They're keeping this alive, Sally.
They sure are, and it's all sort of panning out behind them. They're gaining enough points each race to make it a good score in the end.
Well, SAP Extreme Sailing Team around this mark now, but Ineos Rebels UK are coming in. They've just tacked into third place. Alinghi behind them in fourth. Good news for SAP Extreme. Great news for Oman Air. If you're fans of the Swiss, you've got to cheer them on pretty loudly right now. SAP Extreme Sailing Team cross the line in second place. They're not going to close up on Oman Air, but they will close down the distance on Alinghi. Adam Inoprio did a masterclass on Red Bull at that leeward gate, but he needs to find something else to try and reel in Oman Air. This is Ineos Rebels UK coming across in third place. A good result for the British team, who've been struggling to find the form that we've seen from them in previous acts. Lee McMillan on the helm. Will Alloway, the skipper. Just trimming the forward sail as they come through. And now we get to the main story. Alinghi coming through in fourth. Oh, Sally, what can we read from that body language?
You know, shoulders are a little shrugged. You see the mouths moving. They're trying to maybe, you know, talk about the details of what went wrong there. I still think they're losing a bit on this first beat. And they need to maybe clean it up a little bit. The races that they've come from behind and be able to come through the group haven't, you know, you can't say luck is everything, but they've had some fortunate situations where maybe they need to pay attention to the actual details on the start and that first lane in the tack.
Red Bull Sailing Team come through the line. They really lost out at the bottom of the course when SAP Extreme Sailing Team and Adam Inoprio dealt them a very cruel blow. And then Element Sport Compass Racing coming through in sixth. Team Mexico is going to come through in seventh place, and that draws to a close race 18 and puts a little bit of a pause in proceedings for the moment. We're going to take a little bit of a break here in the commentary booth, but you are not going to want to go anywhere. Racing will continue. We will be back at 3:30 local time, and we are set up for an incredible final showdown here in San Diego. you're looking for idyllic sailing locations with crystal waters and warm sunshine, head to California, USA, and the city of San Diego. Add in a rich maritime history and seven teams made up of some of the best sailors on the planet, and you've got a perfect mix for hydrofoiling action on the GC32s and the battle to be crowned San Diego's Extreme Sailing Series champions in front of the spectators lining the course, cheering on their favorite teams. I'm Niall Meyenbest, and joining me here in San Diego for the commentary is Olympian, Volvo Ocean Racer, and Extreme Sailing Series skipper, Sally Barco. Sally, final day of racing, sun shining, and we're all pretty relieved to see, actually, the breeze is here.
We sure are. Another beautiful day here in the sky of San Diego, and the breeze is just holding enough. Hopefully we get a few more solid races in. We're happy to see the action.
Well, it is a world away from the wet and wild conditions that our teams battled with in Cardiff. As always in the Welsh capital, the Extreme Sailing Series bringing you the best sailors in the world, pushing things right to the limit. It's just going to come right to the line. And Lingi take the ACT win by a single point. Another win for Alinghi in Cardiff, making it their fourth and three in a row. Clearly a team that has risen to the challenge. The SAP Extreme Sailing team threw down last season. And all of this meaning that Alinghi are now 2 points ahead of SAP Extreme Sailing team in second, with Oman Air 4 points behind in third place. Now, Sally, here we are at the penultimate event of this season. If either of these teams want to rein in Alinghi, they need to do it here in San Diego.
They do, and the conditions are kind of, you know, pushing towards it being a possibility. It's a little bit of a risky day on the water. We're still seeing the streaky, shifty conditions. It is almost anybody's game out there.
Well, racing began here in San Diego on Thursday, and out of the blocks, Oman Air and SAP Extreme Sailing Team were focused on not giving Alinghi another ACT win.
One, two, three, listen.
After their near dominating performance at the start of the event, Alinghi started the second day on strong form with a win in the first race. Then suddenly they felt the heat from a recharged and resurgent Oman Air. Phil Robertson and his team found their groove and took 3 wins in a row to pull back the Swiss within striking distance. Adam Manoprio and SAP Extreme Sailing Team also helped show Alinghi that they couldn't relax just yet, also taking 3 wins and squeezing the top 3 teams together at the top of the score sheet. Day 3 was hot, and combined with light winds, it was a hard day for the tacticians, and there was no rest in the quest for speed, as a do-or-die attitude meant that the gambles paid off, with boats being overtaken right up to the finish line. Another strong day for Oman Air, and SAP Extreme Sailing Team keeps the scores tight. That means this, the final day of racing in San Diego, will be crucial. So let's check in with the scores as you join us for the final roll of the dice, the final few races here in San Diego. And Sally, we have had some absolutely incredibly nail-biting racing today, yesterday, and before. Alinghi, at the moment, only 2 points clear of Oman Air, who are in second place. SAP Extreme Sailing Team in third, only a few points behind. Red Bull Sailing Team could still do something if we get a number of points in, but it is close at the top.
It's super close to the top, and it's really, you know, it's an exciting time here with only a few points between these teams, and the conditions are still tricky. We've seen a little up and down performance from Alinghi, Oman Air finding their stride here in the last couple races, and SAP Extreme being a little more consistent across the board.
Well, we know we've got lots of fans of Oman Air, Alinghi, and SAP Extreme Sailing Team cheering them on, but there's also another boat here on the water, the homegrown team, USA flagged, Element Compass Racing. They're in sixth at the moment, and as a wild card entry, the homegrown team are ready to prove their worth in home waters.
My name is Taylor Canfield. I'm the helmsman on Element Spar Compass. So we actually just received a call about a week out from the event. They were looking for a local team. They had some great supporters, Element Sports Group and Spar Compass too. Support a local U.S. team for this event, and getting everything in line last minute, we ended up with quite a good team here. So really happy to be competing and representing home country here in San Diego. We have John Wallace, who's trimming the main sheet on board. Next to him is Sam Halliwell, who's doing the head sail trim. And those two are always, competing everything, from the second we wake up, it's who's going to eat more breakfast, who weighs more, who's stronger. So it's an interesting dynamic, but, when it's time to go out there and race, we get the job done. Next forward, we have Matt Noble. He's doing the floating position. He's a big skiff guy. He's been sailing skiffs for his whole life, and, he's the older boy on board, so he's, enlightens us with all of his wisdom. Then up on the bow, trimming the foils and, taking care of the bow duties is Mateo Vargas, and he's a true surfer boy at heart. So grew up in Florida but lives in California, and he's every morning checking the surf report and watching the World Surf League. Yeah, we're really fortunate to have a full U.S. team for this event, and two of them living out here in California, so two California boys. And definitely the home team at this event, and we love having the home crowd cheering us on. It's really motivating to know that everyone's watching and supporting us out on the water, and hoping that we can continue to get better. And we're fortunate to have thrown a great team together for the event. So I think just going out there and trying to learn as much as we can and put some good races together. The goal is just to improve every day, every race, and just keep growing as a team. And that being said, hopefully we can, put some more good races up on the board.
Element Spark Compass Racing on the waters here in San Diego, ready to prove their worth. And we are getting into the final few races. We have breeze. The breeze is tough, it's hard, it's difficult racing, but it's certainly providing every little thrill and spill. This is going to be how the race course is laid out, from the start up to the windward gate, back down, once more up, and then the short run to the finish. And this beat is proving pretty tricky, Sally.
It sure is, and this first beat is proving even more critical to the actual result of the race. It seems to be hard to come back from the middle of this course if you're behind.
Oh, we've been watching the racing this afternoon. Am I right in saying that the breeze just feels a little bit steadier right now?
It sure does, and sitting here, I think you can feel a little bit of pressure on our backs, which maybe means a little bit of pressure coming from the shore, and hopefully a little bit more consistent across the course.
Well, one of the tactics that has been paying so far, or certainly one of the things that we have seen the teams trying to do, is hug onto that tight shore side of the course. We've been seeing a lot of boats lining up to start in the race on port. At the moment, though, an upwind start, and it seems like people are opting for the more conventional starboard tack approach.
Finally, things are settling back into a normal race course. You know, sometimes they go reaching starts here. The last couple races, we've seen a lot of port approaches. Here we are, mostly lined up on starboard, looking for the right time to accelerate.
Up to a lingy.
Four, three, two.
There's a lot of boats out there on that start line, but Phil Robertson, the skipper of Oman Air, you can hear him. He is only concerned about a lingy and SAP Extreme Sailing Team, and for good reason, because it is those three boats that are very close on the points at the moment. There is only 2 points between Oman Air and a lingy right now. The final race today is going to be double points.
Beckett and go. Deploy, deploy.
INEOS Rebels UK at the pin end of the line. 30 seconds to go. Bearing themselves away, the black mark. The black hull of the committee boat, Oman Air, an early deploy with the code zero, but this could be a key tactic. They're already up to speed. They're holding a lingy high. INEOS Rebels UK putting the bow down, going underneath the fleet. Oman Air wanting to have to try and accelerate through that pack.
7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, mark. All clear.
And it is
all clear.
Good start for Oman Air. Tricky. If they were half a meter further back, that could have gone wrong, but look at them burn the Swiss boat off.
Really great job here from these guys. They, I think, took a powerful control of a lingy at the start and purposely started below them there. It meant that their timing had to be really critical to the line, but look at that. They're burning off a lingy to windward. A lingy are stuck. They have nowhere to tack out. And there goes Oman Air with a bit of boat speed.
Je vois du vent à gauche, c'est très très droite là.
À peine à y aller.
Crew on a lingy, feeling the heat at the moment.
Right.
Arno Serafaga is the skipper, talking to his crew.
Pour moi, il y a du vent à gauche. Il y en a une qui se pose à droite, mais c'est très loin.
Sally, it's bad. It's bad to worse there for a lingy at the moment. They have got Oman Air at the moment right on top of their breeze.
Yeah, interesting how Oman Air started to leeward of them and were able to make this massive transition to controlling windward and in front. Looks like a lingy had no choice. They had to choose a lower and faster mode. This is their only way out. Now they could roll into attack. They finally have some clear air and try to mix things up.
Now we'd expect Oman Air to tack to cover, and they do. As the camera pans around, you can see the Swiss boat, and what a superbly locking position there for Oman Air.
We're seeing some confidence building here, and you know, in the Oman Air team and Phil Robertson, they're able to just maneuver as they want, and they're taking advantage of their position on a lingy at the moment.
Only 2 points separating these two teams on the scoreboard. Almost doesn't matter at how they do compared to the rest of the field. I mean, it's incidental, but Oman Air is leading. Alingi is in second place. INEOS Rebels UK coming up on starboard. They might yet cause a little bit of a problem for the Swiss team. This is going to be important for Alingi here. They don't want to have to go behind the British team. Can they cross in front? Only just. So it's a close cross there, but Alingi survives for now. 60 meters the advantage between Alingi and Oman Air. Look at that, Oman Air just seem to be able to have the height. They're not suffering like the Swiss are.
They are not, and what one thing we've seen them to do here is take their momentum into height. When they're really trying to build speed out of attack, they choose a lower angle, but as soon as the boat's moving, they seem to sail a higher angle. They're sailing less distance across the race course.
Well, there is one other boat that Oman Air and Alingi need to keep a little bit of an eye on. That is SAP Extreme Sailing Team. At the moment, Oman Air and Alingi are just crossing over the top of SAP Extreme Sailing Team. So Oman Air right now, as you can see, SAP Extreme Sailing Team coming in on the left. Oh, they've got a golden opportunity here. They can lock down both boats.
That's right. And you just heard Phil say, we're going to definitely tack on Alingi here. It all is lining up for them. We just have to be careful. There's a moment, I think, in this race where they're going to have to sail their own race. Right now, it's all working out where they can stay in control of everybody. but it's not like they're gaining at the moment. Alinghi is still right behind them with decent boat speed.
Now that's a strong position for Oman Air in anyone's language there. Tactically, they've got that one locked down, but we are coming up to the top of the course. You're a match racer. You know better than anyone. Once you roll into that downwind course, sometimes you're thinking, actually, I didn't want them that close to me.
That's correct. Sometimes you're like, I want a little bit of distance. Or if they're super close, you can control them. But if they're in a free spot, then they have all the power from behind to maybe bring the pressure down to you to sail a little bit lower and faster angle and maybe drive inside and take the roll. We'll see how they choose the gates up here. It's going to be sort of a critical decision. If Alinghi are able to get the split, maybe they create an opportunity to pass Oman Air on this run.
Keeping a little bit of an eye on Red Bull and Ineos Rebels UK coming in here. Alinghi still managing to stay ahead of the British boat. And is it just me, Sally? I mean, we're coming into the top of the course. This has worked out a wonderful first beat for Oman Air. But rarely, this is the first time that I'm hearing the crew on board Alinghi a little bit flustered.
A little bit frustrated. The communication seems to be a little bit more sharp on their point. Like, they actually need to start communicating a little bit stronger to do what they need to be doing. They're holding some close lanes, making some tough decisions, and this top gate's going to be, oh, there they go for the attack, following Oman Air and head of Ineos Rebels UK, trying to keep a controlling position for this second run.
Oman Air have got a very good lead, as you can see underneath the jib. They are extending right now. That second tack for Alinghi, very painful. SAP Extreme Sailing Team, they're not going to follow. They want the space. They want to keep the momentum that they've gained on the later stages of this upwind leg and carry it into the downwind. So Ineos Rebels UK round in third. SAP Extreme Sailing Team round in fourth. And they will be desperate to see Alinghi and Oman Air locking horns, because on the side of the course where Adam Manoprio is heading to, he's got nothing but space. Oman Air at the moment on the top of your screen. Alinghi right now continuing to head out. Now breeze-wise, this is going to be crucial. Both hulls in the water at the moment. The concentration on the crew here of Oman Air, they are going to be looking out for every breath of breeze.
Bow's coming down. Coming up, five.
Sally, there's a telling moment there. Coming up, five. You lose that breeze. Your angle here suddenly changes. You think you're in the lead. All of a sudden, it evaporates.
BMG there, okay?
That's right. I think the angles are what we've been talking about the most downwind. They come with pressure.
Margie,
with a little bit of shift. But we're if you fall out of this pressure, you have to change angle. And that's an instant loss on these runs.
Alinghi look powered up. It looks strong.
They look like they're on a great line to this gate as well. Probably Lang. Looks like they've made some gains on that side of the course.
They're working that boat hard, and I think they're going to be able to round the bottom of this course without bearing away, without putting in an extra jibe. Oman Air, you can see, have had to sail very low, very slow into the bottom of that course, and they are not going to be able to carry a lot of momentum into that upwind track. Difficult to get these boats to accelerate when you're going on board. We've got the guest sailors on board each of this boat right now for this crucial showdown here on the final day in San Diego. Oman Air, round the bottom. Alinghi, round in second. Well, a split at the bottom of the course for Ineos Rebels UK does make things a little bit easier for Oman Air and Alinghi. But a chance here for the British team, because you would expect Oman Air to put in a few more tacks than maybe as fast to gain control.
I think we'll see Oman Air make sure they keep Alinghi in their zone, in their covering zone, with also trying to connect the dots on the race course. There's a chance it's getting a little bit puffier out there, which means the hulls are actually bigger. There's a little more risk, as we saw in that downwind. Two hulls in the water, quite slow, looking for power.
Well, look at how much the SAP Extreme Sailing Team have lost out here. Red Bull Sailing Team on what looks to be a very nice ley line into the bottom of the track over the last few days. We've seen them get some of those lay lines wrong. No such luck on this one. That was beautifully played out. That's going to keep them ahead of SAP Extreme Sailing Team and mean that SAP Extreme Sailing Team risks allowing Alinghi and Oman Air to stretch out and continue the battle for first place with just the two of them. Oman Air still in the lead right now. The Swiss, for the moment, following them. I'm surprised to see the Swiss still going that way. I mean, that to me means that we might be looking at a very one-sided race course.
I agree. I think we're seeing the sort of left pressure not fill in like magic, but it seems to be a bit more consistent than the right, as we've seen the right pay earlier in the day. To me, with SAP Extreme coming closer to shore on that downwind, a big loss. There's Alinghi tacking right now. To me, it looks like they're tacking into a big hole. Maybe they felt a massive header, and that's where they need to actually get on the other tack. This tack is actually taking quite a long time. They need to back the Jennaker around. That windward sheet is what he's holding there. Super tricky tack. They're really stalled dead in the water, trying to figure out where the breeze is coming from.
This is incredible. This is a transition in the breeze. This is a change. You don't need me to tell you what's going on here or how these sailors are feeling, because there is a lot of dejected body language going on. The wind has shut down in the middle. Sally, from where we are here in the race control, in the commentary box, we're watching everything. I mean, looking at the course right now, Oman Air, as we can see on the picture, they're still flying. They've still got that windward hull out of the water. No one else is enjoying anywhere near this much breeze.
I see Oman Air just kind of going with the flow, basically. They feel the pressure. They're not doing anything crazy maneuver, any trying to second guess the breeze. If they feel the header, they might think about attack. If they feel the pressure, they're just keep going straight. Alinghi might have made a massive mistake. They're trying to push the limits into attack.
One more rounding, one more windward mark, one more tack for Oman Air. The yellow boy just coming into view in front of them. They need to tack, bear away, and then that short run to the finish. Behind them is Ineos Rebels UK, but a good way back. Then we have the Swiss team, Alinghi. The breeze looking like it's coming in a little bit better now across the course. Red Bull Sailing Team in the middle, about to come into view on your screens. They're making some gains right now. That's going to push Alinghi back. That's going to push SAP Extreme Sailing Team back, and that's going to play into the hands of Oman Air. Phil Robertson is round the top of the course. It goes to show how quickly that breeze can come back in. They're now downwind. They're flying a hull. They're just riding that pressure a little bit down and into the finish. That's a very good camera angle to show just how streaky the pressure is at the moment. Well, race 19 crucially goes the way of Oman Air, and for the first time we see Alinghi really underperforming. Boats between them and Oman Air will mean the points look even better for Phil Robertson and his crew. You can see the smile and you can hear the words. He knows what this means. This position here, this result, puts Oman Air in the lead of the scoreboard in San Diego. Well, you don't need me to commentate. Phil Robertson's doing it for you. He's talking about what's happening right here. Red Bull Sailing Team is pushing Alinghi off the lay line for that windward mark. Ineos Rebels UK cross the line in second place. A great result and normally a big story, but unfortunately, Red Bull Sailing Team around the windward mark. Sally, Alinghi tacking out, and SAP Extreme Sailing Team coming in as well.
Oh, it is all going wrong for Alinghi here.
I've never seen Alinghi looking so vulnerable. Normally the team that would be down the field and always manage to find their way through, the consistency in their sailing, things go well, things go bad, absolutely solid. But now, it looks like, as a team, the temper is starting to control the boat.
They need a full regroup here. I think they were trying to push the points earlier in that race. That tack, you saw Brian Metro, the arms going up in the air from the crew members, from the trimmers. What are we doing? We're trying to push the limits of the boat too far. We're trying to tack in no wind instead of just sailing with what we have. And then again, they get tacked on by, you know, Red Bull Sailing and don't make the mark and lose one more crucial point to Oman Air.
One more crucial point to Oman Air, and SAP Extreme as well close up. Going into today, Alinghi were 5 points ahead at the top here in San Diego. It looked like SAP Extreme wasn't going to be able to challenge them. They might be able to do it. Difficult moments for the Swiss team here in America. They need a regroup, and they need to recharge. Two more boats still having difficulties out at the top of the course. I mean, the breeze is up, the breeze is down. You need to be ready for these changes. Element Spark Compass certainly looked like they were. They are now rounding on the inside of Team Mexico. The two boats, they're not going to get stuck. They're both coming round. The breeze is now filling in, but it does push Team Mexico back into seventh place as Element Spark Compass and Taylor Canfield coming down to the finish with a nice little bit of pressure.
The replay of that thing at the top mark would be golden as well.
Element Spark Compass coming into the finish line just ahead of Team Mexico, crossing the line in sixth, and then seventh place for Eric Brockman.
Race comedy, this is Red Bull, we need a 5 minutes damage delay.
And Red Bull, what'd you break?
We have a hole in the hull from the start, crash with Mexico.
Okay. 5 minutes it is.
Oh, Sally. I didn't see that collision on the start line between Red Bull and Team Mexico, but clearly something bad enough.
Yeah, it must be just a puncture that I guess they're looking to put some good old-fashioned duct tape on. Hopefully it doesn't leak all the way through. If it was more than that or under the waterline, I think we'd be seeing some bigger actions to make sure that they don't take on too much water.
Well, the big news here, Oman Air on that result goes into first place. Alinghi get pushed into second place. It was 2 points, the advantage to the Swiss. Now it is 2 points advantage to Oman Air, and we can speak to Phil Robinson on board the Omani boats. Phil, well, congratulations. You seem to be in the lead.
Well, we've had three bullets in a row, so that's always a nice thing kind of racing. So momentum's on our side at the moment, and we've just got to keep it rolling, that's for sure. A horrible race right now. It's more about luck and where you're positioned, but a little bit on the first top off the line. So we've managed to put ourselves in the right spot in the last three races and get around the track pretty cleanly. So, more of the same.
It seemed like you've got under the skin of Alinghi. Something seems to be unravelling. I mean, Red Bull at that final windward mark probably didn't help.
Oh, look, yeah. No, I don't know if we've got under their skin or not, but they're having a few shockers, so momentum's against them. And again, it plays that way. So there's to play for. I guess two more races and heaps of points up for grabs. So it's just as easy to win a race as it is to come last. So we've got to be focused and keep doing what we do.
Well, I know you got a lot at stake. I know you want to get back to it. Good luck. Keep up the work.
Thank you.
Well, a little bit of humility there for Phil Robinson, as he said. You know, it's just as easy to win as it is to come last. It is snakes and ladders in this race course right now, but what an incredible race. Let's just take another look back at that start. This was a key moment here for Oman Air and Alinghi. Beautifully placed.
Beautifully placed, well-controlled position on this starting line. Obviously nailed the acceleration. We've seen them do that in these last few starts, which gave them the advantage off the line. But not only that, they controlled Alinghi and started to ruffle their feathers right here, I think.
And I didn't think that Oman Air would be able to make this position just so damaging for Alinghi. They won that lane, pushed Alinghi back. I mean, Alinghi had, well, nowhere to go. They had nowhere to tack out.
It's the beginning of the frustration I think you start to see in the team. They had nowhere to tack out. Then they had finally, when they do have some space to tack, it's a tough tack. And then just a tricky spot on the line. This is where they actually tried to get through the tack. They didn't make it through. They try to back the sail. It backs the wrong way. They're stuck head to wind. A big righty actually on the race course that nobody could see. The crew's arms go up in the air and they have to reset, but it's the beginning of losing a few crucial points to them on air.
And then of course, this moment at the Windward Mark where Red Bull rubs salt into the wound and they just got hung up again. I mean, if you were coaching Alinghi, if you had the ear of Arno Sarafakis, what would you say at this point? So difficult to reset when things don't seem to be going your way.
Super difficult to reset, but this is a really strong team, and they actually had something, some little bit of magic early on in this series with, I think, a little bit of boat speed, and they just need to go back to the basics, a normal coaching position where, hey, guys, just take a big, deep breath, figure out what's the simple thing to do on the race course and let the boat ride a little bit. Try not to do too much to make everything happen, because it's not magic out here. It's just let it ride.
Well, that moment at the Windward Mark allows Oman Air, with taking the win, to really push the points to their advantage. And now they, of course, finish in first place on that race and move up into the top position on the scoreboard, 2 points ahead of Alinghi. SAP Extreme Sailing Team, of course, still in the hunt as well. All the sailors on board wanting to take this win. One, of course, being the rising star, Julius Hellstrom. A big name building here in the Extreme Sailing Series and wanting to make every impression on what's to come.
I grew up on an island in Stockholm Archipelago, and go for a morning run and stuff. You can go say hello to the cows, and yeah, it's pretty cool. I started sailing when I was 5 years old. It was my first race in this small regatta around Stockholm. When I was younger, I grew up playing a lot of ice hockey. Mainly, it's a really good way to work out. It's really awesome, and Sweden is a perfect place for that. Gets you kind of in good shape for any other sport you want to do. My job is to be a second-hand help to the other boys, pulling the ropes, being as strong as I can. Yeah, the boys, they think I eat a lot of food, and especially potatoes, so the garbage man eats all the food. That's my...
We're really struggling to feed him. He's an eating machine, you know. We've got probably one of the strongest guys in the whole fleet here, so it's good having Jules on there, but we've got to feed him.
Sure, that's everything. I mean, you spent your whole year trying to win a thing, and to win the Extreme Sailing Series would be a big, big step in my career and the boys' career. The team is capable of doing it again. I feel like I've been part of the team for a long time now.
Well, SAP Extreme Sailing Team, they're in the hunt here, Sally. I mean, we were talking a little bit about Oman Air and Alinghi, but SAP Extreme Sailing Team, on the points at the moment, they're only 7 points off from first place. They could still do it here. And of course, we know that the final race is going to be double points. That means they can jump 12 points to their advantage. So Adam Minoprio has got every reason to still feel like the trophy could be his.
He sure does. And what we see here with SAP Extreme Sailing is that they have some consistency going for them. They seem to be, whether they start in dead last or very first place, they seem to be finishing second or third place, fourth place at their worst. They need to probably pick apart one key thing to do a little bit better on the race course to make that a second or first in these next couple races. If they can be first in the last race with that double points, they have a shot at this first place overall.
And if SAP Extreme Sailing Team find themselves in first place, we know tactically they can lock it down. That is something that we haven't seen from Alinghi. The Swiss, certainly in the last race, becoming a little bit unraveled. But, you know, maybe we're doing them a disservice. That's the first time I've seen them look rattled.
I agree. That's the first time they sort of all of a sudden tried to do more than was possible with this breeze. It's not a breeze that you can actually manhandle the boat. You have to let the pressure come to you, and you can only tack really when it's telling you to tack. And that's one thing that Oman Air is doing really well.
Well, Oman Air, as you say, they've done it really well. I always enjoy hearing from Phil Robertson, the skipper of Oman Air. As he said there, when I said to him, well, you know, congratulations. Well, we have just made it three wins in a row. Momentum is with them here at the moment.
Momentum's with them, and I think their placement and time on distance on the starting line is giving them so much confidence about this race course that they're able to do whatever they want. They've the only boat to start on starboard, the last consistent three or four actual starts. It's been the right shift in accordance with the course, which gave them an advantage off the line.
Maybe. I think you got Lee there. Okay, Bell's coming. Yeah. Phil.
Oman Air lining up for this start. I mean, just before we did come on air, Sally, the first race today, Oman Air did underperform. They did have their, shall we say, you know, what Alinghi did in the last race. They were sort of doing well. It all unraveled, and they just kept slipping back and hemorrhaged positions. From there, they picked themselves up. So we could still see that from Alinghi. This is going to be the racetrack that we're going to see this battled on. And this harbour wall is coming into play again and again.
It sure is. You can't actually do one tack on this course. It's limiting you to do multiple tacks. It's becoming an advantage to tack in the right place, but this wall can be advantage or disadvantage to teams that getting all the way to the right side of the course.
Well, for the first time, I would say that we haven't seen consistency in the breeze on that harbour wall side. The last few races, it was very much you want to get into there. That seemed to change in the last race.
Yeah, I think we're getting later into the day here. The general trend of this breeze is that it's stronger on the right as it's building, and then as the sun is starting to go down and the breeze is starting to change a bit, the left can be great, but it's not consistently a win on either side of the course is what I'm seeing.
30 seconds to go. So far, conventional looking start for most of our teams. We've got Team Mexico coming in on port. Oman Air, along with Red Bull, Element Spark Compass, unfurling the code zero and starting to accelerate.
Speed. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, mark. All clear.
Great start for SAP Extreme Sailing Team, flying the windward hull. Not so good for Oman Air and Ineos Rebels UK.
Tough ley line there, a little bit shy, but Oman Air just had some nice pressure and now they're able to power over the top. We'll see if they can hold their lane. Not much space to tack.
Red Bull sailing team, first boat to lose the lane, first boat to tack out at the moment at the bottom of the course. Breeze is good. Ineos Rebels UK, they have Oman Air, Element Spark Compass on top of them. And then Alinghi and SAP Extreme Sailing Team. The positions here of SAP Extreme Sailing Team, Oman Air and Alinghi are crucial at the moment. Alinghi, if they finish in this position, will reclaim the top spot. Now, this is going to be telling now for Phil Robertson. Got room to tack, has options, what does he do?
Okay, stand by. Two, one, go.
Oman Air rolled into attack, breaking free of the loose cover from Alinghi and also sailing underneath SAP Extreme Sailing Team, but Alinghi tacking right on the top of them. This is what we saw Phil Robertson doing to Arno Sarafakis, now reversed.
Advantage Alinghi, and then SAP Extreme actually follow suit and they tack right on top of Alinghi. We have a match going on here. These three boats are, they know it's all to play for in these last couple races. The points are close and you see Oman Air taking a clearing tack out. And here we go. I bet Alinghi might follow with them just to stay in control of this race. It almost doesn't matter what's happening anywhere else on the course. These three boats are where it's at.
Well, so far, Oman Air have tacked off. Alinghi don't seem to have followed them, but in the previous shot, I did see the Code Zero flogging on Oman Air. They could have had a little bit of a problem. Now they seem to have it under control. SAP Extreme Sailing Team, I'm sure, will be grinning ear to ear, because as those two teams slow each other down, it plays into the hands of SAP Extreme Sailing Team. Have a little look at the 3D graphics here. Look how that yellow trail of SAP Extreme Sailing Team has ticked upwards.
Yeah, nice left-hand shift that they're dialed into. They're sailing the longer tack up the course right now. Hard for them to tack off, both Alinghi and SAP Extreme, as they're actually making distance towards the mark.
SAP Extreme Sailing Team keeping Alinghi under control for the moment. Oman Air on the far side of the course, attacking and losing out to Team Mexico, who are on starboard, but it was an easy cross for Team Mexico. Oman Air look like they're going to keep their breeze clear, but you can see the damage of that extra clearing tap.
This is going to be a tricky tap of the race course here. Doesn't look like anything has any magic. I wonder if we see Oman Air pulling back a little bit of distance on these leaders, but right now quite strong here from SAP Extreme, and Alinghi's just on their tail coming out of the right, the top right.
So the leaders, SAP Extreme Sailing Team, Adam Rinoprio on the helm. He'll be very happy to be back in the lead. Now there's good pressure right now on the top of the course, and I did see SAP Extreme Sailing Team late to deploy their code zero after the tack. I wonder whether we're getting close to that crossover on some of these gusts.
Yeah, it looks like they are fully powered up, fully hiking out here, and starting to depower the mainsail, so maybe they don't need the code zero in these big puffs.
SAP Extreme Sailing Team at the top of the course. In the background is Oman Air and Alinghi, but Adam Rinoprio bears away the left-hand turn and up onto the foils. Foiling here in San Diego as the breeze comes good for SAP Extreme Sailing Team. Not such a good story for Oman Air. Alinghi ahead of them right now. This could be the moment that Arno Sarafakis reclaims the top spot on the scoreboard. He needs to get a boat between him and Oman Air. On board Alinghi right now for the bear away, and it does sound tense, but they're up on the foils. Alinghi also foiling away, sailing over the top of Red Bull Sailing Team. Oman Air trying to follow suit. Will they also foil on the way down? Have they still got the breeze? Oman Air just foiling right now. Look at Alinghi on the left-hand side of the screen. Alinghi foiling away, Oman Air trying to foil, but it's not consistent. Well, the breeze has run out for these two teams. Alinghi jibing over. Meanwhile, SAP Extreme Sailing Team, look at the speeds. 19 knots for SAP Extreme Sailing Team. Up on the foils, Adam Rinoprio in the lead, sailing the perfect race course and just flying away.
Really settling in these puffs. It's so nice to see these boats getting up on their foils and flying and seeing this is what we want them to be doing. This is their best condition.
Beautiful Mark Rowning for SAP Extreme Sailing Team. One jibe required on that downwind leg. That's the kind of thing that gives you the momentum for the beat. Alinghi now in the breeze, 20 knots of boat speed. Behind them, Oman Air is chasing, but they are not matching the speeds. Look at it, 16 knots for the Omani boat. This is going to be good news for Alinghi here. They're going to look very confident in second and might still have a chance to close down SAP Extreme Sailing Team. That's tough for Oman Air. No such falling into the bottom.
Really tough, and you can see the difference. I don't know if it's the actual pressure in the moment, but when Alinghi was flying, they are so stable that they're able just to keep accelerating into that 20 knots. Oman Air never got there on this whole run.
Really? Okay, copy. No, holding straight, going straight.
Telling moment there. Conversation between Phil and Peter, the tactician. A call for attack. Then it was there were a little bit of a change.
Board down.
We've seen this team
good chance, Stewie.
A little bit frayed. We don't want it to unravel right now, but they have got a formidable battle with SAP Extreme Sailing Team in the lead. Well in the lead. Look at Ineos Rebels UK. Still going downwind, but the angle that this boat is sailing at right now, it's almost like they're on the upwind leg. Ineos Rebels UK is going downwind. Lee McMillan is checking underneath the hull because he knows he needs to go behind SAP Extreme Sailing Team. Now he does, but they have no breeze for the British boat. Well, look at this. Look at Alinghi. Look at Oman Air. Oman Air have been able to close this up a little bit. You'd expect a little bit of compression as the boats come round the bottom of the course.
Wow, but they've gained a lot. They've taken a lot of distance out of Alinghi there. I think we're seeing the breeze change once again, and I think Oman Air just sort of short tacked it. They had a little more angle at the bottom and tacked before Alinghi, and now they're back in striking distance.
Can Oman tack from there? Alinghi will be on starboard. Is that too close?
From here, it looks like it's too close. You can see them out here just to leeward of Alinghi there on that leeward hull. They're going to be wanting to sail a higher mode, trying to squeeze them off, giving them bad air. They're not afraid of going slower here, but they need to sail a higher angle.
By my eye, it seems to be working. The gauge between the two boats is being compressed. Phil Robinson knows that he needs to close that lane on Alinghi. If Alinghi here sail Oman Air to the ley line, to the side of the course, you give this one to the Swiss.
It's slower now, eh? Keep talking, Pete.
Keep talking. That communication is so important right now. Phil cannot see Alinghi over his shoulder. He needs to do the play-by-play about what angle he needs to sail to give Alinghi this bad air.
So far, so good for Oman Air. Both boats going slow. Too slow now for Oman Air.
They're getting to a point here where if Alinghi tack, Oman Air can match attack, and then it'll be really powerful for Oman Air to be roll over the top. Any farther, Alinghi will have the power because they're going to be over ley line into this last turning mark.
SAP Extreme Sailing Team at the top of the course, but we are going to stick with the battle here for second place. But the battle for first place in the overall scores in San Diego. Now this is very tender sailor sailing right now. Phil Robinson ready to make his move. Alinghi tack. Oman Air tacking on top. Everything needs to be perfect here for this tack. Now don't be confused. SAP Extreme Sailing Team through the line. It's all going to be about that windward mark, but it's not the mark we can see at the moment. It's the one to the left.
That's surprising. Alinghi did a great job there. I really thought they were too slow into that tack. If they can lay this mark, they're going to stay in control to the finish.
Both boats at the moment pinching, sailing slow, trying to gain control. Oh, it's a tack off for Oman Air. Oman Air deciding that they weren't going to lay that mark. They tacked over. This is going to put the rules into Oman Air's favour.
And you also have Ineos.
Go. Stand by tack.
Ineos Rebels UK taking full advantage of what's happening right now. They managed to find a little bit of a gap. Lee McMillan and Will Alloway thread the needle and make their way through. But it doesn't matter one jolt to the scores of these two teams right now. Oman Air just fractionally getting the boat up to speed a little bit faster. They're attacking now on Alinghi. It's the short reach into the finish. And Oman Air in a very strong position right now. The breeze is on for Alinghi. They luff. Oman Air defending as well. Both boats are laying the finish line. It's going to come down to the single centimetre that you can pull out from this breeze. Oman Air are rolling over the top of Alinghi. That was an incredibly hard-fought win for Phil Robertson. It's third place on the water, but they hold on to the top spot in San Diego for now.
Nice one, lads.
Wow.
There is relief in the voice of Phil Robertson there.
That's for sure.
Well, Alinghi come through the line in fourth place. Blink if you miss it. Ineos Rebels UK across the line in second. Next to come through, local team, the USA boys, Element Spark Compass Racing. Taylor Canfield on the helm coming through. They finish in fifth place. Red Bull Sailing Team struggling a little bit in that race, coming through behind Element Spark Racing. In sixth, and then in seventh place, it is going to be Team Mexico. Wow. Okay. Okay. What started off in that race, as a three-way match racing battle, I mean, it almost felt like SAP Extreme Sailing Team got a little bit of a gift and were able just to sort of sail clear as the other two just locked together.
I think that's the advantage they have with the little bit of point gap they have to the two leaders. Obviously, you know, Alinghi and Oman Air have to pay attention to each other. It's touch and go with them. But you know, SAP Extreme did a great job not getting into the mix and just stretching out their lead.
Incredible scenes out in the water right now. Oman Air will be very happy about the way that that played out, but of course it was only the last few seconds.
Yeah, copy. I was just in that breeze. It's quite nice if you just go cut, little fill, and then go.
Yeah.
But I can, I'll speed up the first part. Cool.
The points are as follow Oman Air 211,
Alinghi 208,
SAP 206, Red Bull 183,
Ineos
176.
Now, Sally, those are the scores being read out right now. And I could see Marcus Lynch, the coach of Oman Air, with his phone or a tablet there. And I'm guessing that he was checking those numbers, checking the combinations, because they need to know exactly what the game plan is for the next start. Likewise, this boat here.
Yeah, they're going to break down these scores and figure out how many points between each other they, or how many boats between each other they can actually handle. It'll determine their game plan on the starting line and the game plan into their tactics for the entire race. Can they actually give the other boat a little bit of breathing room, or do they have to just suffocate them and put the hammer down?
Well, Alinghi, look, a little bit drawn, but one boat that's going to be feeling very good about life at the moment is SAP Extreme Sailing Team. Adam Manoprio, the helm. Well, congratulations. That was a good victory, but it really does look like all of you are having to fight right the way to the last meter.
Yeah, it's very tough out here, very light and very shifty, and difficult to go the right way. And fortunately for us, Ineos did us a favour there and got us a bit closer to Alinghi and Oman, so I think it's going to be all on for this last race.
A rare moment in the last race in terms of match racing, where you were able to lock down not only Oman Air, but also Alinghi as well. And that kind of set you up for the rest of the race.
Yeah, no, it was good to have those two back in the fleet and fighting each other. And that helped the fleet all to pass them and us to extend. But we've just got to make sure we engage Alinghi, but not hard, because it's very easy to maybe one lose three, so that could be okay for us. But with the slight situations, you can easily pass people on the downwind.
Well, the scores mean that victory here in San Diego could still be yours. We'll let you get into your pre-race preparations. Good luck. Adam Manoprio on board SAP Extreme Sailing Team. I mean, let's have a look at some of the big moments from that race. Who needs breeze in the Extreme Sailing Series? Whenever it gets light, it gets incredibly intense right now. Let's take a look back from that start. Oman Air, in the previous start, sailed an absolutely beautiful position for that leeward end, but actually it was SAP Extreme taking the windward option that worked so well.
I believe they won the race right there from that start. Sailing the longer, you know, the longer tack in pressure, nailing the line, in control of the race right from the gun.
And that put Oman Air under, you know, quite a lot of pressure early on. As we heard from Adam Manoprio, they kind of got locked into a little bit of a battle with Alinghi after slipping out from their lane from the start. And from there, I mean, it really was just a tactical battle. Alinghi and Oman Air matching each other, tacks for tacks, all the way up. And the timing on some of these maneuvers, absolutely crucial. That moment at the end of the race was incredibly close.
Super important for Oman Air there to stop the game, control the boat, and then again react here at this windward mark. They were actually tacked out first, which gave them the option to tack again here. Ineos, Rebels UK made it around, didn't really matter. But the other two boats were able to match, and in the end, Oman Air was just able to roll over the top.
And it really did come down to those final few moments. I mean, Phil Robinson and the crew on board Oman Air did not know that was going to go their way just until just before the finish. Difficult for Alinghi, a hard pill to swallow, but they've still got the speed, they've still got the tactical prowess, and we know that they're going to do it. It does seem like Red Bull are going to have to pull out all the stops on the final few races to feature in that top three. But we know that the final race here is going to be double points. We know that Red Bull have got it in them, not least one of their big new signings, Michael Wilkinson, a big name in the Foiling Phantoms and now a big name in the Extreme Sailing Series.
My name's Michael Wilkinson. I'm from New Zealand, and I am the foil trimmer on board the Red Bull GC32. I started quite young. I started at the age of six. My mum got me into it. I'm from the centre of farming country in the Waikato, New Zealand. So just sailing on lakes, Karapiro and Naroto, before moving up to Auckland with university and kind of really getting into it. I suppose late teens is when I really cracked on and really started to enjoy it. And you know, it kind of became a career choice after a few good results. And this is one thing leads to another, and here we are. Oh, the Red Bull foiling generation is an amazing opportunity. We were, you know, sailing small boats in New Zealand, and all of a sudden Red Bull come along with these flying phantoms and give us kids all a go, and it was just awesome in Auckland. So yeah, the Red Bull foiling generation just gave us so many opportunities. We won the world final in Newport a couple of years ago, and from there kept in touch with Roman and Hans, and we've sailed their Flying Phantom and the Flying Phantom series as part of the Extreme series for the last few years. Had a lot of fun. They're awesome boats, and this week finally got to make the step up onto the big boat for the first time, and it's just been eye-opening. And yeah, I'm a lot smaller than I think I am, but it's been so much fun. Yeah, the Flying Phantom and the GC are very different machines. They sail on that three-point foiling configuration. So the way you sail them is quite similar, but obviously the weights ramp up on the GC. Everything's a lot heavier. All of a sudden you've got five people on the boat to deal with. A lot more on, as you might say, trying to organise five people and, you know, three sails all the time. So yeah, that's working as a team's been a bit of a difference. The theory's the same, and we're trying to do the same thing. So a bit bigger, a bit heavier, but maybe a bit slower. But yeah, no, they're a lot of fun. Being part of a GC32 team compared to a Phantom or an Olympic campaign is, you're dealing with professionals. This is their job, and day to day they're great at what they do, and they take it seriously. It's been a real learning. I think I fit into the mix as quite the small young guy, you know, coming in at the bottom and trying to work his way up. I'm just loving learning off the guys, and it's a lot of fun working with the Red Bull boys. This week, yeah, for me, is all about learning and getting to know people. And you know, Phil Robertson, Adam Minocri have been my kind of childhood heroes growing up, the World Match Racing Tour champions. So I've always followed them, and to sail alongside them and, you know, be competing and occasionally beating them is super exciting. So yeah, that's what this week's all about, is getting to know the guys, learning. And long term, you know, it's going to be all on for the next 2 years, ramping up to Tokyo. So I'm not sure if I'll be back after this year, but I hope to be back. It's so much fun. The boats are awesome, and I'd love to be back.
One of the names that we're going to be hearing a lot more from in the Extreme Sailing Series, Michael Wilkinson. But for now, let's get back to the action. After 20 races here in San Diego, we have got a very interesting situation on the scoreboard with Oman Air, 211 points, 3 points clear of Alinghi, who are in second place. SAP, Extreme Sailing Team, they are 5 points off first place. And normally, that would count for something. That's a reasonable score sheet. However, we are getting into the final stages today, and we are about to race the last race here in San Diego. The last race, double points. So, Sally, we're going to do the maths as the race is going on. Well, we're not. The computer's going to do it for us. But essentially, we've got a situation here where Alinghi, to regain the top spot, they can't just beat Oman Air.
That's right. They'll have to keep SAP Extreme behind them as well, because I believe with only the 2-point deficit, if SAP Extreme beat Alinghi, then they'll win in the tiebreaker. So yeah, it's going to be all on with these top three boats, and it's not quite going to be a match race, because you can't just control one boat. You have to keep everybody in your pocket.
Watch here in the final 25 seconds of the countdown to see where Alinghi line themselves up and how they do this one. We're on board at the moment with Oman Air, underneath Ineos Rebels UK. Team Mexico lining up for the port start. Alinghi underneath Oman Air. For Alinghi to win this one, they need to beat Oman Air. They need to put a boat in between them and Phil Robertson. Gun fires, Red Bull very close to that line. And it looked to me like Red Bull were over the line. We'll have to wait and see. Ineos Rebels UK look dead in the water. Red Bull coming back for the start. So, off the line, it looks like Alinghi onto a very strong start. There's Oman Air just to their windward side, pressure, lining up with SAP Extreme. So there we go, Sally. Top three teams.
What a great setup. Right now, they're all focusing on their speed because right now speed is king. So if they gain a little bit of distance, all of a sudden they're going to be in control of the race from the front. If they lose a little bit, right now we're seeing Omani are going just a tick slower than Alinghi. They're holding on to their lane. I believe eventually as time happens here, Alinghi will gain control of this top group.
There was pressure on for Alinghi. Now is the turn of Oman Air. With that pressure, could come speed, could come height. That's the decision that the sailors will want to make. It looks to me like Oman Air is electing to take it high, wanting to squeeze out SAP Extreme Sailing Team.
The modes are just crucial here. You hear Phil calling what angle he wants to sail to stay in this lane. Right now, it doesn't look like Oman Air has the ability to even tack because of the other American team there. They might be stuck. They're forced to hold this lane and possibly take an early loss.
Relatives, please. Looks, okay. Yeah. And then,
same. Calm demeanor in the voice of Phil Robertson at the moment.
Up you come.
SAP Extreme Sailing Team to windward of the pack. Oman Air and Alinghi, look at that. They've really pulled themselves up. The heat is starting to come on to Oman Air right now. Now, is that my eye, or have we got a little bit of a right-hander coming in here across the course?
A big right-hander. We've seen almost all starboard tack so far. They're actually nearing the top quarter of the beat here. They do have one tack into these gates, and it's going to be a shorter tack and probably a big header and aiming right back at us at the booth on the shore.
Now, Oman Air can allow Alinghi to win this race, but they need to finish right behind the Swiss. If a boat or more than one gets in between Alinghi and Oman Air, it means that Alinghi will win, provided they've got SAP Extreme Sailing Team behind them. Well, here comes the tack for Alinghi. It's crucial. It looks good. They're through the breeze and they are into the pressure. The windward hull is flying as the crew come up. SAP Extreme Sailing Team, they've tacked off early. Oman Air holding on to the stern of Alinghi. That's good enough for Phil Robertson, but he needs a good tack. Doesn't look as strong as the Alinghi tack there.
No, I'm really surprised he didn't match a tack with SAP Extreme there. He just needed to say, as you said before, control that third place boat, and he elected not to tack right with him, now giving SAP Extreme a chance at starboard here at the mark.
Well, first tactical decision, Alinghi putting in the extra tack, attack bear away, not a fast maneuver, but they think that the breeze is on the right-hand side as we look down. Oman Air following them. This could be Phil Robinson deciding the best thing to do here is to get a good finish just behind the Swiss and not gamble.
Okay, wait up. Up. Down.
Well, there go wait Oman down. Air for the bear away.
Bear's coming up.
They've lost a little bit of distance to first place Alinghi, but they've gained a bit of distance on SAP Extreme Sailing Team. I'm impressed that Oman Air are rounding in the position that they were, because it looked like their lane off that line was going to do a bit more damage.
I totally agree. I think they worked super hard on that long tack. They knew it was the long tack. They had to really hang there, really adjusting the modes to force themselves to stay in the second spot.
They've got some early depth out from the mark here. They've managed to go a little bit low. SAP Extreme Sailing Team going a little low, but they haven't elected to jibe aggressively on their windward hip. Alinghi on the left-hand side of your picture. Look at the speed that they're doing right now. Up on the foils, and when the Swiss get flying, they get fast.
It's amazing, isn't it? The stability you see, how quickly they get on the foils and how quickly they level the boat out. It's unseen by any other team so far.
Well, it looks like the tactic for Oman Air in this race is going to be match racing SAP Extreme Sailing Team. Easy to say, but the helm on board that boat is Adam Renoprio, and he knows something about match racing. Fantastic foiling on board Alinghi, over 15 knots on the way down to the bottom of the course. Just stropping off the foils right now, but still flying that windward hull. They're going to round the leeward mark with a pretty impressive lead.
Okay, virement rapide, les gars.
Oman Air have let them go. Oman Air are sailing high. They know that the real battle is going to be with SAP Extreme, not with this boat here. Still in first place, rounding comfortably with a good lead. It's Alinghi. sadly for Arno Sarafaga, it's not enough to win this race. He needs to have a boat between him and Omar Nair. We've still got another lap to go.
Yeah,
once more back to the top.
Agree.
And the reach to the finish.
Yes, copy.
It's a super tricky situation because Alinghi actually needs to almost go back
bottom.
And force Omar Nair back into the group to actually win the overalls.
Hey. Oh, look what's happening here. On the 3D tracker, we have got Alinghi tacking over, and I almost wondered whether that was Alinghi.
I'm almost going to soak
just
this
rolling
in,
the
boys.
Dice. Just seeing, well, if we interfere with them, we do. It wasn't to be, and Omar Nair sailing low into this bottom mark. They're not on the ley line.
Jiving
coming into
and
this
going
one low.
Left.
They're going for a jibe, but still want that left-hand turn, so it's going to be a slow rounding here.
Okay, jiving back. Here we go. Jive, Phil.
Now, this is crucial.
Go, boys. Go. Big ones, boys. Big ones. We're not far off attack, okay?
What does SAP Extreme Sailing Team do? Do they jibe to follow, or do they keep the speed?
Okay, stand by. Three, two.
I think they have to. They have to go for the split here. They have to put a bit of risk in the bank. And you heard Phil say there, if he goes the other way, we immediately tack, which means he's nervous. He's nervous for them to actually get a split on the course. Phil and the Oman Air team just want to slow the game down. They want to stay in control of SAP Extreme Sailing and control it from the back of the group. They're fine if Alinghi stretches out as they are.
All of this is not going to make any difference to the position on the score sheet for SAP Extreme Sailing Team because Alinghi is leading right now. If they beat Oman Air, that does not move them up third spot, but it does deny Oman Air the victory here in San Diego.
It looks all good straight ahead, doesn't it?
Now, if you really wanted to think conspiracy here, if SAP Extreme Sailing Team wants to win this season of the Extreme Sailing Series, they do not want Alinghi to get another win here in San Diego. They want Oman Air to win here.
Yes.
I said conspiracy theory.
Yes, that was a big conspiracy theory. We're getting deep. But you're right. They could lay off the pedal a little bit here, let it all pan out as it is. I think that's probably a super hard thing in this competitive nature of these sailors. But I think it's panning out. Alinghi is just stretching out their lead, and they're not coming back to put the hurt on Oman Air to change the game a little bit.
Alinghi, look, gone. They have stretched out. They have just tacked over. Well, I was going to say it should be their last tack, but actually they look pretty headed at the moment. They've just started to come back up, but they're not laying the top of the course. But with those numbers, 325 meters between Alinghi and the next boat. Now, missing from that 3D graphics is Oman Air. I think we might have just had a little bit of a blip in the transponder of Oman Air, because Oman Air is in between Alinghi and SAP Extreme Sailing Team. And Oman Air have tacked over, but it is very light at the top of the course. Look at Alinghi, big lift now. They're just laying the top mark. It's just out of view. Oman Air, here comes that painful speed build that's so necessary out of the tacks. The power's now with Oman Air. Alinghi
right.
Have gone.
Hi, right, here, boys, keep that trap down. Main sheets go, he's gone back. I think my one. 20 seconds.
Yeah. Do you agree?
Oman Air are still looking like they're going to take this win. Alinghi are going to the finish line. They're going to cross this line. There won't be any celebrations for Arno Sarafakis, but he is finishing in style. Alinghi across the line, and they will keep a very close eye on what happens with Oman Air. They need to have a boat finish between them and Oman Air. And look at this. Could it be Team Mexico? On the far side of the course, they are sailing in a little bit of pressure. Oman Air right now are covering SAP Extreme Sailing Team. At the moment, they are set to win here in San Diego by a single point. SAP Extreme Sailing Team, can they do anything from there? Look at this, Sally, a little bit of a right-hander for SAP Extreme Sailing Team. Just what they didn't need.
Oman Air set up just in a really powerful position, controlling from the right. The Mexico team has a long way to come back to the gates. One more attack in for Oman Air.
Oman Air, one more tack to go. This is it. Surely they can start to smile. Surely they can start to feel pretty good. What was the winning move? Wasn't in this race. It was in the previous race where they just managed to pip Alinghi on the line. Oman Air tacks, bears away around the top of the course for the last time in this race, for the last time in San Diego. Watch for the celebrations here on Oman Air. They're not letting go of their nerves yet because they haven't yet crossed the finish line, but there is no one around them. Alinghi claimed top spot in this race, the final race, but Oman Air have got the points and they win in San Diego, breaking the winning streak of the Swiss and keeping the overall series alive. Wow, what a final day for Oman Air. It started off on the back foot. They didn't look strong. What a regroup.
What a regroup. You know, they just executed what they needed to so well today. They took the win and they stayed in control when they needed to, and then they slowed the game down at the critical moment. And I'm really surprised that Alinghi didn't take some notes from that race and come back and try to slow them down. Probably an impossible task. What a team.
Don't worry about your chase, mate.
Celebrations on board of Oman Air, and it looks like their entire staff are desperate to get into the photo as SAP Extreme Sailing Team crossed the line, third place on the water in race 21, and that will put them third place on the podium in San Diego. Oh, they did everything that they could do there on SAP Extreme Sailing Team, and a very strong finish in that final race for Team Mexico. It's not going to be enough to move them up the leaderboard, but a good way to finish here in San Diego. Well, it was set to be difficult conditions. It was set to be trying. There was a risk of having no racing today at all. But actually, we have had a set of phenomenal racing out here. Tricky, tactical, yet with foiling as well.
That's right. We saw some fantastic foiling on the downwind legs, making the boats just separate from each other, some really stable sailing, and then some really tricky light air maneuvers as they go upwind.
Red Bull Sailing Team round the top of the course for the final time. Roman Agara back on the helm here, along with his long-term partner and fellow double Olympic gold medalist, Hans-Peter Steinecker. They cross the line in fifth place. That will see them on fourth on the overall scoreboard. Almost had a chance this morning to get on the podium, but they needed the other teams to falter, and sadly, they didn't. INEOS Rebels UK wheeling across the finish line here. Lee McMillan on the helm. Will Alloway working hard as skipper and as foresail trimmer. They cross the finish line, crossing in sixth place. And then sadly here, the last boat to cross the finish line is going to be Element Spark Compass Racing, the homegrown boat. But a boat that, you know, you look at their scorecard, they've had some good results here, but it's all going to be about Oman Air. I still think that there's a lot of celebrations, but there's also a lot of relief. That was nerve-wracking.
That was very nerve-wracking for these guys. Remember, they started the day before we went on live with a really tough race, and they had a massive regroup. It was a successful regroup. They realized what they needed to change on the race course. They needed to not be afraid of tacking the boat where they wanted and reading the breeze really to the detail. They went on to win three races in a row and then to take control from the lead from there.
Well, this is something that we saw quite a bit of here on this race course. You never want to see a boat this far behind on the race, not least the homegrown boat. They put in a great scorecard, though, especially when you consider the crash course that is learning to sail, the GC32. But the top of the course here in the Extreme Sailing Series here in San Diego, I mean, pretty much that's where all the action happened. That's where boats lost, where boats gained. I mean, INEOS Rebels UK stealing places from both Oman Air and Alinghi. Unfortunately, this is where Element Spark Compass have a little bit of a tough time with two extra tacks to come through into the finish. Well, Element Spark Compass now bearing away and sailing through, the boat that's enjoyed the biggest cheer from the crowd as the homegrown team. All American, two of them from California, and sailing in these waters for not the first time. Sadly, weren't able to light it up for the final race, but Element Spark Compass now across the finish line. That brings the final race here in San Diego to a close, an event which certainly held out that final result all the way to the finish. Well, for those people that came out here to watch the final day of racing, last year that we were in San Diego, we had breeze, we had top speed, we had great foiling. Wasn't too much of that on the cards here, but my word, what a tactical showdown.
It sure was, and for what the forecast was this morning, I think we got very fortunate with the breeze, and it made for some really fantastic racing.
Team Mexico now packing the boats away. Of course, the action doesn't stop here in San Diego. We still have one more act to go. So let's have a look at the standings. Let's see how these points have affected things. Well, Oman Air take the win in San Diego on the final race by a single point. Alinghi cruelly pushed down into second place with SAP Extreme Sailing Team rounding off the podium in third. Red Bull Sailing Team finishing in fourth. And Ineos Rebels UK disappointing fifth with Element Spark Compass, the USA flag boat, in sixth. And then Team Mexico in seventh. So the overall standings for the 2018 series. Alinghi, four wins, but their winning streak comes to an end. They still hold on to the top spot, but 3 points behind them is SAP Extreme Sailing Team, and then 5 points off the top spot is Oman Air, now with that win in San Diego. Everything is still possible in that final competition that we've got coming up in Los Cabos. And we can talk now to Arno Sarafagas from Alinghi. Arno, disappointment in San Diego, but you still hold on to the top spot for the series overall. It looks like Los Cabos is going to be very interesting.
Yes, for sure we would have loved to win here in San Diego, and a little bit frustrated, but I think we did the job because the plan was to be ahead of Oman, SAP, sorry. And it's what we did, and a great congratulations to Oman Air that they deserve to win here at least one during this season, yeah.
Well, you won in Cardiff by a single point. Now Oman Air wins in San Diego by a single point. I mean, we really have got some of the best teams in the world here in the Extreme Sailing Series.
Yes, for sure, it's really tight. Maybe we should only do the last race and we'll be the same.
Arno, you'll get my vote. Good luck and keep driving hard. I'm sure you're going to bring it all to the line in Los Cabos.
Thank you very much.
Already looking ahead, already regrouping, already remembering that actually, in terms of scorecard overall, Alinghi are definitely the boat to beat. However, in San Diego here, it was all about Oman Air. And we can hopefully speak now to Phil Robertson in just a moment. But just look at the smile that he has on his face. Today was difficult. They had to regroup and they had to work very, very hard. But they did it. They're sailing past the shoreline now, celebrating with the crowds that are cheering them on. Marcus Lynch, the coach, just steering them in. And Phil Robertson on the helm. In just a few moments, we'll be able to hear from them. But they've still got to put that boat away in an orderly fashion because, of course, this competition has got to see them through to the next act where they're going to need just about every single piece of sailing skill that they can because, of course, Alinghi are ready to fight back. Well, we can hear now from Phil Robertson. Phil, what an unbelievable final race. I mean, first of all, congratulations.
It's been a good day, to be honest, and yeah, obviously came down to a point in the end with Alinghi, and it just goes to show how you got to scrap for every point, and I think we won that point in the race before on the last reach to the finish, so we're a happy team and set ourselves up nicely for the last race, but yeah, look, it's a tough, tough competition, and yeah, we're stoked to finally get a win this season.
Coming off the line, you guys were locked into that straight line battle, but I wonder at what point did your mind realize, Alinghi, they've got this final race. We need to lock down SAP Extreme Sailing Team.
Yeah, probably three-quarters of the way up the first beat, I guess. We obviously, Alinghi had quite a jump, and that was a bit gutting, but we knew the fight was with SAP. As long as we could keep right on Alinghi's heels, we'll be in a good spot, and racing to the left, we seem to be doing that. So to make SAP flick out a bit early sort of gave us a little bit of breathing space, and we knew we could put the hammer down there and try and keep them at bay.
Now, you've got every reason to celebrate here in San Diego, but of course, Alinghi's scorecard in the series overall talks for itself. What can we expect from you guys in Los Cabos?
Yeah, look, Alinghi's had an amazing season. They've almost been unbeatable, and they're a solid team, so very nice to take one off them. And look, there's three teams at the top that are extremely good at the moment, and look, we'll be going to Mexico to win the event, that's for sure, and it's sort of out of our hands what happens after that. But yeah, the season's definitely not over, and yachting, it's never over till it's over. So it's an interesting sport. You've got to be focused right till the last.
Phil, we're going to lose you in just a moment, but I just got to say, it seemed like a real team effort. Your coaches, your shore crew, everybody contributing to this win.
Yeah, there's eight of us here in the team, and everyone has a massive piece of the pie in the outcome of the performance. And then we've also got a team of probably about 40 back in Oman. So it's a huge team effort, and it's what makes the win. And that's why you see these, I guess, top three teams so strong, as they've all got really solid teams and years of experience behind them. So it's a team, and everyone has a massive piece of the outcome.
And of course, Pete Greenhouse, a little bit banged up after Cardiff, but a nice way to get back into Extreme Sailing Series racing.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Like, we had a bit of a nasty crash in Cardiff, and Pete got pretty injured, and he just spent 6 weeks recovering. So it was nice to have a little break and get him back to sort of 100% and back on board. So yeah, here we are, race win. It's a nice place to be.
Well, I know that the celebrations, they'll want to get started. I will leave you to it. Congratulations to you and all of your team.
Nice. Cheers, guys. Appreciate your help.
Well, there we go. Phil Robertson, you can hear the smile. You don't need to see it, but I don't want to burst their bubble. They've got every reason to feel very, very happy with themselves, but I'm sure that SAP Extreme Sailing Team are going to push very hard. And Alinghi, of course, still the boat to beat.
That's right, and when it comes down to the big picture of the series, you hear Phil say that, you know what, they're going out there to the next event just to win it, and they have it in their pocket now to do so.
Well, let's have a look at some of the key moments from that race, because the big thing was just how quickly we got set up into this straight line battle. It looked like Red Bull Sailing Team were going to get into the mix. Sadly for them, they were called over the line. And then after that, it was just that 1-2-3 lineup.
Not a surprise. All three of these teams knew it was going to come down to this last race. They probably don't want to set up too far away from each other in the starting line, which would set up this scenario just dependent on who was going to be lured, who was going to be the possibility of being in the middle and or lost to windward.
Well, those three teams lining up right here, this would have been crucial for Alinghi, Oman Air, SAP Extreme Sailing Team. And important to remember here, I mean, I know all these teams would have known what was at stake on the scorecard, but Alinghi didn't need to be beaten at this point in the race.
That's right, and I'm really surprised that they didn't take a moment and actually sail a little bit back towards Oman Air and just see if they could slow the game down, maybe force a mistake on Oman Air to put one more boat between them and try to take the win of the overall, of the event here in San Diego.
You say that, but what I thought was interesting going around this course, Alinghi on fire, foiling, sailing really well. We knew that they were going to be crisp and polished once they get out into the lead, which meant, of course, a match race between Oman Air and SAP Extreme Sailing Team. On paper, you'd say that Adam Inoprio would have the edge.
I don't know. You have, Phil Robertson, who's a past, match race world champion in multi-hulls. He knows exactly what he needs to do, when he needs to slow the game down. He wasn't stressed about SAP. He felt comfortable around the course. I don't know. If I was Alinghi, I would be maybe looking back and saying, we probably had an opportunity to control the race there and we didn't take it.
Well, there was, of course, one moment before this moment here where Alinghi crossed the finish line where they could have done something. We did see them try to interfere with Oman Air as they were coming back upwind. But Oman Air held their nerve and I think crucially realized when they needed to change their game plan. It was no longer about the Swiss. It was all about SAP.
It was all about SAP. And, you know, Oman Air did a great job of forcing SAP to attack early on that first beat, taking their clear air, taking the turn around the bottom mark, and then controlling on the second beat and having an easy reach into the finish.
Oh, Phil Robertson already smiling before they come through to the finish. A lot of reward, a lot of happiness about winning here and what that means to the series overall. But just think about the journey emotionally that these sailors have been on, especially today. We were lucky enough today to be able to listen into some of the debriefs on board. And for the first race today, that challenge of regrouping after being in the lead, and losing three or four places, and then to come back to have a clear headspace and be able to perform.
That takes a lot of respect for each individual on the boat. And you heard Phil talk about the big team they have behind him. Everybody's working hard to figure out the details of what they need. It takes a lot of respect from each other to listen in a way when it's a high-pressured situation, and they did that really well. There's a few things thrown around about what they need to change, what they need to focus on, and they went out and simplified the race and did it really well.
And it's very nice to hear Phil Robertson talk about the support staff that they have. There's eight of them out here. We've got Matt has them out there driving the boat. Marcus Lynch, who we've mentioned before, the coach. Loads of people looking after all the foils, and of course, back in Oman, looking after the team, the finances, everything. Of course, it is a team effort. Everybody's working very hard.
20 seconds to what?
Well, one of those key players, of course, is the Omani sailor on board, Nasser Al-Mashri. He's making a big name for himself, and he's leaving quite a big impression behind in Oman.
My name is Nasser Salman Mashari. I'm from Oman. I live in Muscat. I born in Muscat. I've got a family here in Muscat, eight brothers and three sisters, and we are very close to each other. I get very, very big support from them, and I'm happy for that. I'm traveling a lot with the Oman Air and Oman Sail as well, so I miss home a lot. People here, and culture. I love the culture in my home country, so still missing it there. But when we're going traveling around, we take this culture back to the other countries, and then we show them how we are. I'm not doing it for myself only. I do it for Oman, for His Majesty, for people, you know. And to me, this place, this sand of Oman is most dear than anything else in the world. I would like the rest of the world to see how we are live here in Oman with a beautiful culture and a beautiful nature. When people ask me, Nasser, I mean, what you do, when I tell them sailing, they was so shocked about sailing this and what's exactly. By now, I mean, people, they're not surprised because sailing coming more popular in Oman, and people now, they like to sail a lot, and the young generation, they're pushing hard, and I'm so happy and proud to be support them. And I'm sure we'll have a great future for sailing.
Well, Nasser Al-Mashri was on board on the crucial moment, to use Phil Robertson's words, where he won this event. Wasn't in the last race, it's in the race before, that final win with Mark.
That's right, and they took control of the race by actually slowing it down. They had to pass Alinghi here, and they're on the wrong side of them. They have one more tack into the mark. They slowed the game down. Alinghi had to tack at their slowest moment. Oman Air match right attack with him. And actually, Alinghi here come through with some pace, which was surprising, but then a crucial moment at the top mark where they have to put in another tack. As they get...
Sorry, you're just talking about meters here, and when you're saying about surprising, they got the speed. The thing that really surprised me was Ineos Rebels UK managing to come through fine. Alinghi managed to hold on in that position for as long as they dared. But you're talking about meters. I mean, where do you lose meters? Everywhere. One step in the wrong position, one slightly late tail on a sheet, and all of a sudden, that cost you San Diego. A superb moment for Oman Air, one I'm sure they're going to debrief and think, well, if we're in that situation, we know what to do again.
Well,
Well, great sailing from Oman Air in San Diego, but they need to turn it on for Los Cabos. That is going to be the showdown. It's going to be presented by Element Sport Group, and we are going to see the final points on offer in this edition of the Extreme Sailing Series. Will it be Alinghi? Will it be Oman Air? You will have to tune in and find out as we get to the final event in the Extreme Sailing Series.